glory. They are led by the minister of defense, Reggie White, who's breaking all the quarterback sack records at the University of Tennessee. But Ole Miss has won three in a row and is showcasing a new quarterback, number 6, Kelly Powell, who replaced the struggling Kent Austin. The Rebels' leading receiver and runner is number 10, Buford McGee, here in action against Tulane. Ole Miss is on a three-game win streak. For the 50th year, it's Ole Miss and Tennessee.
NCAA College Football. Tonight's game features the SEC battle between the Rebels of Ole Miss and the Volunteers of Tennessee. Tonight's game is brought to you by Chevrolet. Chevrolet is USA 1, and USA 1 is taking charge. By Coors. Now, the best of the Rockies is yours from the Adolph Coors Company, Golden, Colorado. By Purolator Courier. Overnight Express on your terms. You want it, you got it. And by Cable News Network and CNN Headline News.
One company provides cars and trucks to satisfy the wants and needs of virtually every man and woman in the USA. That's today's Chevrolet. One company for some of the world's most advanced manufacturing and design facilities to work for America. That's today's Chevrolet. America, you're on the move again. And Chevrolet is providing your wheels. And you.
Live from Neyland Stadium in Knoxville, Tennessee, the University of Mississippi, the Rebels of Ole Miss, and the Volunteers from the University of Tennessee. It's a homecoming crowd, a sellout at Neyland Stadium, and the Volunteers are on a five-game win streak. They are 6-2, and they believe they are bowl-bound in 1983. The Volunteers are coached by their alumnus, Johnny Majors, who was a great tailback here in the 50s. And Ole Miss, 4-5. They've won three in a row. They have a new head coach, Billy Brewer, who was a great All-American at Ole Miss. Two guys who coached at the coaching at the schools that they won at when they played are here to meet tonight in a Southeastern Conference shootout. It's a little cold in Knoxville, 40 degrees at kickoff. It's going down to about freezing sometime during the football game. And we're expecting an old-fashioned shootout. Tim Foley, my buddy from Miami, is a little nippy but ready for the ball game, and it ought to be a good one.
Yeah, I've got my earmuffs with me. Tennessee's offense is really cranked up. Alan Cockrell came to life against LSU the last time we were here. Has played well. He's got a bevy of running backs being led by Johnny Jones, who last week had 234 yards running the ball. Tennessee's strength, though, is their defense, and that's led by Reggie White, who's an Outland Trophy candidate and the Lombardi candidate. Mississippi is going to play close to the vest on offense. They just try not to beat themselves and try to control the ball and keep their defense off the field as much as they can.
We've got a lot of great individual stars we'll be looking at tonight. Some great running backs, as Tim said, and some great defensive players. And we're expecting a typical Ole Miss and Tennessee football game. They started playing back in 1902. They have played for 50 years. It started out until 1945. Tennessee just beat Ole Miss all the time. But since then, Ole Miss, in the last 34 years, it's 17-17. You never know what'll happen when these two teams tee it up. As I say, the coaches are interesting as they both come back to their alma mater. To coach, Billy Brewer at Ole Miss and Johnny Majors at Tennessee. It's homecoming in Knoxville. Stay with us. We're looking for an old-fashioned Southeastern Conference Southern Rebellion from Knoxville. This all started back in 1902, interestingly enough, in Memphis, Tennessee. But tonight we're in Knoxville. UT and Ole Miss, 31-17-1. Tennessee leads in the series. And last year, Tennessee defeated Ole Miss 30-17. And Tennessee running back Chuck Coleman, who's been hurt but is possibly going to play again here tonight, had 134 yards for the Volunteers. It's kind of chilly tonight. If you live in the Midwest or someplace in the northern part of the United States, you're going to say this is just great football weather. But here in Knoxville, Tennessee, they think it's cold. It's 40 degrees and will be down to about freezing by game time.
You see the captains out of the middle of the field as you look at Johnny Majors on the sideline and his Tennessee Orange. Tennessee won the toss and declined the decision, meaning that they have reserved their decision on whether to kick off or receive until the second half. Normally that means that the opposition, Ole Miss in this case, will elect to receive the football and probably go on offense for the first time. And if that's the case, we get to see their new quarterback, Kelly Powell, who came in that Vanderbilt game and has really kind of given the team a lift, Tim.
And it's a good decision by John Majors. The strength of the Tennessee football team is their defense, leading the Southeastern Conference in total defense, leading the Southeastern Conference in pass defense. So they're doing a fine job in that area, and they can get good field position by holding Mississippi on this first possession. There you see Billy Brewer. You got these Rebels excited. They've won three in a row. They believe that they can take Tennessee. If they don't make any big mistakes and hand Tennessee any easy points.
Fuad Reves, as you look at this crowd, it's a capacity crowd at Neyland Stadium, about 92,000. There's Fuad Reves, the Tennessee kicker. He has kicked it into the end zone all about 30 times. He's kicked off 44 times. Only 15 have been returned this year. Lee Davis is on the left side. Stephen Cunningham and Andre Rogers are on the wings. Lee Davis is the deep man. He wears number 9 for Ole Miss. He had a 65-yard kickoff return versus LSU. He's a burner. Lee Davis, basically a defensive back. He averages about 22 yards per kickoff return. But as I say, that is often a moot point when Fuad Reves kicks off for the University of Tennessee, as he often boots it in and or out of the end zone. There's a wind tonight of about 10 miles an hour from the north, but down on this floor of the stadium, as they call it, Shields Watkins Field, there's not much of a wind. Should not be a factor. Here's the kickoff. It's going to come down short. It comes down to the man on the right wing. That's Andre Rogers. Rogers out to the 17 or 18-yard line, and Ole Miss will set up their offensive attack right there. First of all, let's look at the offensive backfield. Kelly Powell came into the Vanderbilt game to replace Ken Austin. He's thrown three touchdown passes. Buford McKee leads the team in rushing and in receiving, and Arthur Humphrey, the fullback, could be the key to the game. He's rushed for 300 yards in the last four games that Ole Miss has played. First down 10, Rebels from their own 18-yard line. There's a quick handoff to Buford McKee. They'll try to get him the ball 25 times tonight if they can. When they're throwing the ball, you can look for these people to be catching it. In addition to McKee, a little fella, 5'9", 160 pounds, Jamie Holder. Timmy Moffitt is the second leading receiver, 28 catches, two touchdowns. And Michael Smith, the tight end, primarily a blocker. He's only caught four passes all year. It is second down 7. Ole Miss with the ball just outside their 20-yard line. The handoff goes right up the middle again. This time it's Arthur Humphrey, the fullback. McKee is 10, Humphrey is 40, and they'll try to alternate the handoff to those fellas when Ole Miss keeps it on the ground.
They're running to the left side of that offensive line, Sheehan and Clark. Clark has started for Dan Boyce there, as you see the offensive lineman lined up. And they're running away from Reggie White, and they're getting to be like a lot of football teams in that sense.
Conversion situation, third down 3. Line of scrimmage is about the 24. Here's Powell on the option. He goes to McKee. First down, Ole Miss to the 31-yard line. Penalty markers go down. Terry Brown with the tackle for the Volunteers. Buford McKee, number 10, found new life this year under Coach Billy Brewer. He started in 79, got 137 yards in his first game, went 58 yards the first time he touched the ball, ran into a lot of problems after that, however, and just now is really finding himself as a big-time offensive back here in the SAC. Bob Aye is the man in the white hat. That is the referee marking off the penalty. It is against Ole Miss, nullifying the first down, and here's the announcement.
Flipping, offense, third down.
A clip call on the first down run, so it's now third down, 12, Ole Miss, and it's a passing situation. Ball is at the 16-yard line. They're going to do a draw, but nowhere to go for Buford McKee. And now, thanks to the penalty, it was Reggie White with a tackle, by the way, number 92 for Tennessee. You'll be seeing him time and time again tonight. There he is. They call him the Minister of Defense, Tim Foley. Leads the SEC in sacks. Quarterbacks aren't exactly fond of him either.
We'll talk about him a lot tonight. He'll make himself, his presence known. He gets across the ball and gets off the ball as fast as anyone I've ever seen. And he's quite a story.
Bill Smith to punt, averaging 41.5 yards per punt. This is a pretty good one. It's driving Tim McGee way back to his 28. Down at the 41-yard line. Good field position for the Volunteers of Tennessee. McGee, also a wide receiver you'll be seeing in there a lot tonight. Number 88 with the return for the Volunteers. In front of their homecoming crowd. It's another sellout here at the University of Tennessee at Neyland Stadium. The Volunteers, who lead the nation, lead the SEC in total defense, showed you why as they stopped Ole Miss on the first opportunity for the Rebels. Alan Cockrell, the quarterback. Johnny Jones is the tailback. Johnny Miller is the fullback. It'll be Lenny Taylor, Clyde Duncan, and John Matthews, the receivers for the Volunteers, on a first and 10 from their 42. Play fake. Cockrell has a man. Incomplete at the 44-yard line, intended for Tim McGee. Eric Truitt was covering, and here is that Tennessee backfield. Alan Cockrell has erased a lot of his early season mistakes and playing very good football right now. He can run it as well as throw it. Johnny Jones had 234 yards against Rutgers 2 weeks ago. Jimmy Miller, freshman starting at fullback. Randall Morris and Sam Henderson, the guys that Johnny Majors would rather see at fullback, are playing hurt tonight. We'll probably see them some. Sam Henderson, as a matter of fact, just came into the game. He wears number 43. He's the fullback for the Volunteers. Cockrell. It is complete to McGee this time, out to the 49-yard line. Short of a first down. And let's take a look at the receivers. McGee in there now. Lenny Taylor plays the wing back position. Clyde Duncan is the leading receiver with 24 catches and 5 TDs. And John Matthews plays tight end and alternates with John Cook. John Matthews sometimes plays tackle. When he does, he changes from number 95 to number 72. Third down, 3, Tennessee, from their own 48-and-a-half-yard line. Here's the tailback, Johnny Jones. He gets the first down to the 44-yard line. Ole Miss Rebels.
Rutgers saw a lot of that last week. You saw him just give a little dip, a little move, and then bang, upfield he went. And he's got an offensive line that's doing an excellent job. Singer, Furness, Streno, Mayo, and Knight have really helped this running game by knocking people off the ball. The last three games, they controlled the line of scrimmage well.
First down, 10, Tennessee, from the 45-yard line of Ole Miss. Three wide receivers in for the Volunteers now. Two split to the left, one to the right. Cockrell comes to the left. There's number 24, Clyde Duncan. He's hit out of the open field. He gets close to the 41-yard line. Andre Townsend, number 80, is a fine defensive tackle in his own right for Ole Miss. We've got a couple of real good matchups of defensive tackles here. Andre Townsend, they call him the Big Dre. You'll see why as this game progresses tonight. He's a big pro prospect also. 6'4", 265. Second down, 7, Volunteers from the 42. Cockrell hands it off. Up the middle, close to a first down, goes Sam Henderson, the fullback. They'll have to bring the sticks in possibly to make a measurement here. Let's see where they spot it. There's that defensive front for Ole Miss. They'll have their hands full, Tim.
Freddie Nunn, excellent pass rusher, great speed. Hubbard leads that linebacking core, and Hall in the defensive secondary is really quite an athlete.
And Davis, number 9, the right cornerback you saw there, has had 3 interceptions the last 2 games. There's the measurement. It's very close. Tennessee short by inches. And so Cockrell will get some instructions from the sideline from the University of Tennessee Offensive Brain Trust. They send in some more beef. A couple of tight ends in here and bring out a couple of the smaller wide receivers guys. McGee and Duncan comes out. Tennessee with double tight ends in there now. It'll be third down inches. Tennessee ball just inside the 35-yard line of Ole Miss. We're in the opening quarter to play from Neyland Stadium, Knoxville, Tennessee. Volunteers 6-2. Ole Miss Rebs 4-5. The Volunteers have won 5 in a row. And Ole Miss has won 3 in a row. Now a little trouble getting things started down there on the sideline. Let's see what Cockrell finds out from the official. Had some clock adjustment problems here before we started the ball game, and they may be having those during the game tonight. All right, on the short yardage, Tennessee has 2 fullbacks, 25 Miller and 43 Henderson, and 1 tailback, 33 Johnny Jones back there. And handoff to 43, Sam Henderson, and Henderson gets the first down to the 33-yard line, and Tennessee keeps their drive alive. We appreciate the sign.
Right, yeah. I wonder who does his makeup.
There are the standings. You know, it's mathematically possible for Tennessee, Alabama, Georgia, and Auburn to tie for the SEC lead. If you look at the bottom half of the SEC standing-wise, and of course, Auburn defeated Georgia today, making that even more possible for Tennessee. Here's McGee. Drives to the 23-yard line. That ought to be enough for the first down. Lee Davis with the tackle for Ole Miss.
Walt Harris is the offensive coordinator for the Vols, and we're going to see this play again. This is their third first down situation. This is the third time they've thrown the ball. They're going to try and loosen this thing up a little bit. They like to keep a good balance in their offense, and last week they had to run the ball a lot versus Rutgers because of the strong wind that kept them on the ground. They're going to air it out a little bit tonight.
Tennessee started this drive with good field position out about the 43-yard line of the Volunteers after a fine punt return by McGee. Now they've driven it down here to the 22.5-yard line of Ole Miss and are on the move. A lot of folks are a little cold here at Neyland Stadium, but I think they're pleasantly surprised. There were some real horror stories in the newspapers here in Knoxville about it getting down to 20 degrees by the end of the game, and a lot of people might stay home, but even as I read it, I thought, no, not at Neyland Stadium in Knoxville, and it is a full house. They love their football here in Knoxville. The Balls are on a roll, five games they've won in a row. Hand off to Johnny Jones, goes off the right side for only three. Tackle by number 20, Dwayne Nesmith, the left linebacker for the Rebels of Ole Miss.
Exactly what Tennessee wants to do. What Mississippi is thinking defensively is prevent the quick score. And right now they're going to have to lock up a little bit man-to-man.
Nickel backs. Five defensive backs in there for Ole Miss. Cockrell rolling and looking. It is complete. Number two, Lenny Taylor with a reception. Touchdown, Tennessee. And Alan Cockrell also just became Tennessee's all-time leading passer. Moving ahead of Jimmy Streeter.
Defensive backs, a little counteraction in the backfield. Lenny Taylor was wide open, obviously a blown assignment in the secondary. Lenny Taylor from Southridge High School down there in Miami, having a fine year for the Tennessee Vols.
Fourth touchdown reception for Taylor on the year. Here's Reves. Mr. Automatic is good, and the Volunteers have taken a 7-0 lead over the Rebels of Ole Miss with 9:41 to go in the first quarter from Neyland Stadium in Knoxville. So Tennessee just drove it in and scored. Cockrell, 4 out of 5, throwing the ball. It took him 3 minutes, 18 seconds, 58 yards, 9 plays. Lenny Taylor, the wingback, with the touchdown reception from Cockrell. Cockrell, by the way, has now thrown on the season 11 touchdown passes. There's the Reves kickoff. It comes down to Andre Rogers. They wisely hold him in the end zone. Rogers almost brought it out, which would have been disastrous for Ole Miss. Now they get it out on the touch back to their own 20-yard line, trailing 7-0. And let's see if Kelly Powell, Humphrey, McGee, Moffitt, Holder, and Smith, in terms of the skill players, can get it rolling.
The penalty on the third down situation on their first possession could prove to be a very important factor here. That would have given Mississippi some confidence. Now they find themselves behind 7-0 early.
The movement, some penalty flags down there. I'll tell you something. This Ole Miss team comes in here to Neyland Stadium just like every other football team. It is tough to play in front of approximately 90 to 95,000 people. We'll get an official count later. And I'll tell you that it's like the 12th man for Tennessee, this large crowd.
Offsetting foul, dead ball, first down.
Offsetting, so both sides were off, probably the defense first in that case. Dead ball, and it'll just be played over again. That's the voice of Bob Haye, the referee tonight, the man who wears the white hat. So it'll do it all over again. First down, 10 Ole Miss. They're in a pro set offense, which you'll see most of the night, meaning those backs will be in that wide split. Here is Kelly Powell. Pressure. Throws under pressure. Incomplete. But I'm afraid Kelly Powell may be seeing that a lot tonight. Number 98, Mark Studaway, blew in from his right tackle spot. You hear a lot of talk talk about Reggie White, but Mark Studaway can play some ball too, and Bobby Majors can talk about that.
He's the best I've seen as far as speed, quickness, size, strength, aggressiveness, and being a tremendous leader. We play well as a team normally, period, but he makes us become an outstanding defense by his all-around play.
There's Powell getting it out to the 24-yard line. He was, of course, talking about Reggie White. Studaway and White are the bookend defensive tackles for the University of Tennessee. There's Reggie White, number 92.
Very, very active in the Fellowship of Christian Athletes, and a lot of people find it expedient to be associated with that organization, but this kid is just unbelievable. He's just a picture book athlete and human being, just a great kid.
Third down, six, Ole Miss from the 24-yard line. Kelly Powell has a man deep, incomplete. Good catch-up coverage back there. Charlie Davis, the free safety, got over there to help out on the play, and it goes incomplete.
Tennessee in a two-deep zone, and as most of the folks know out there, one of the soft spots in this zone is down the sidelines about 20 yards. Charlie Davis comes over from his weak safety position and causes an incompletion, ball a little bit overthrown. Davis had a key interception against LSU, and he's kind of the fellow that makes all the adjustments in that secondary.
Here's Bill Smith, first time out. He hit it 56 yards. This one not so far, but it's high. Fair catch at the 34-yard line by Tim McGee, number 88. And there the Volunteers will have the ball. That punt was a 42-yarder by Bill Smith. Volunteers lead 7-0. Well, there you see the sentiments of some of these Tennessee Volunteer fans. They're talking bowl bid, the Gator Bowl of the Citrus. There are representatives from two of six bowls who are represented here tonight with scouts taking a look at this game. Also, the Hall of Fame Bowl is here, and it gives me an opportunity to tell you that Hall of Fame Bowl will be on Turner Broadcasting December 22nd. We'll be announcing who will be in the bowls next Saturday night. By the way, November 19th is the earliest date to pick bowl teams. Down 10, Volunteers from the 34. Cockrell
going upstairs. Almost picked off, penalty marker down. Number 24 for Tennessee is Duncan. 16 for Ole Miss is Eric Truitt.
The flag down on the field, Bob. Let's see what happens here. Once again, first and 10, they're throwing the ball. Cockrell airs it out deep. Duncan down one side, Taylor down the other side. Nice play by Truitt. Goes up well for the football.
Interestingly, Tim, they throw that penalty marker against Tennessee. And from the replay, maybe you spotted a former defensive back. You can see that better than I, for sure. I didn't see a penalty there.
No, I didn't either. It must have occurred before we picked up the two players going up for the football.
Somebody like Clyde Duncan, the senior from Oxon Hill, Maryland, is an experienced player. He may have kind of hip-rolled off the defensive back before the ball was thrown or before the penalty marker came down. They move the ball back to the 19-yard line of Tennessee. It will be second down, 25 Volunteers. 8:36 remaining first quarter. Tennessee leading 7-0, but they find themselves in a hole here. Cockrell, short drop and a quick toss. It is complete out to the 24-yard line to Tim McGee, who rotates in there at the split-end position with Duncan. It's McGee and Duncan at split-end, and mostly you'll see Taylor at the wing-back position receiving-wise for Tennessee. And there's Cockrell, 5 out of 6 throwing that football now.
Well, when they're in a passing set, they're going to come with three wide receivers. Their tight ends are good blockers, they feel, but they leave a little bit to be desired as far as movement down the field, so they'll have three of them in there most of the time.
Two receivers to the left, one to the right side of the line of scrimmage on this third down 20. Cockrell running out of the pocket, incomplete, trying to get it out here to about the 39-yard line. He was looking for McGee, but he was under a lot of pressure. Tennessee, after they got themselves into a hole back there with 25 yards to go for the first down, cannot convert, and now Jimmy Colquitt will come in to punt the ball away for the Volunteers. Colquitt, one of the finest punters in the country. He's second in the SEC in punting with 42.5 yards per punt. One in the long line of great punters here at Tennessee. Wilburn and Moffitt, twin safeties, are back for Ole Miss. It's going to come down to Wilburn. Up the sideline, has a lane.
markers are down everywhere, however, back at about the 36-yard line. So that'll probably come back on Ole Miss. That's usually the indication. Let's see if it is. Hold it a second. I see yellow flags down there, but there are a whole bunch of them. It may be just debris. Now, there you go. Clipping is against Ole Miss. We were at one game earlier this year, Tim, where fans were throwing yellow paper on the field, which caused some confusion.
Let's see. That's what they call the clip, that block right there. And it's sometimes tough. But you got to get your head around front of that the man that you're blocking.
Bob Aye, the official, apparently his microphone is not working, but as you can see, it is clipping. It is against Ole Miss, and once again, penalties have nullified what would have been a fine return on the punt. We have 7:41 to go in the first quarter, and we'll be back in just a moment. Neyland Stadium in Knoxville, the Volunteers leading the Rebels of Ole Miss 7-0. You can see it here on the Superstation. Now Ole Miss has the ball. Finally, first down 10 from their own 22-yard line. That's McGee out to about the 23 and no more. He was tackled by 45. Tennessee's left inside linebacker, Carl Zander. See beside him there, 44 Toles. They call Zander meat and potatoes and Toles dessert. Zander fills in there and then Toles kind of cleans them out. There's that Tennessee defensive line, the linebackers, and the defensive backfield for the Volunteers. Second down, 9. Ole Miss on their own 23. Powell to throw. Has a man over the middle. It is complete out to the 32-yard line to the tight end, Michael Smith. Tackle made by freshman Terry Brown, the right cornerback.
Well, Mississippi has been successful moving the ball on the ground in recent games. And as you mentioned early, Arthur Humphrey has really come on. They've got a good inside running game, and a lot of times they'll just run the dive, block it straight man-to-man, and let him pick his hole.
Now double tight ends on a third down one for the Rebels. There's a handoff, and it's good. It goes to McGee, and he gets the first down. Buford McGee is 6 feet, 200-pound senior from Durant, Mississippi, leads his team in rushing and receiving, and he's playing, by the way, with a sore shoulder. Matter of fact, he has a minor separation that he suffered in the Arkansas game, but he's been playing tough this year. First down, 10, Ole Miss from the 35-yard line of the Rebels. Powell on the option. McGee gets a couple and not much more. Down he goes. First hit made by cornerback Terry Brown. Dale Jones also on the tackle, number 54 for Tennessee.
McGee has been a fine back for them for 4 years. He has had injury problems throughout his career. This is as healthy as he's been. And he's also a little bit more mentally tough than he's been. He's playing better hurt now.
Second down, 7. Only a four-man rush by Tennessee. Powell gets it off to his tight end again, number 91, Mark Smith. It was Dale Jones with the tackle. Michael Smith with 2 catches, and that's half as many as he's had all year. He had only 4 coming into the game.
Ball control passing. Dragging the tight end across the field to sit right inside that weak side linebacker. Split end, running a curl behind it. The quarterback makes the choice.
Now they've got double tight ends in there. 91 Smith, 85 Joyner. It is third down, 3. There's the inside handoff to McGee. He may have gotten it. I believe he did. McGee just popped it over the left side. Johnny Williams, the middle guard for Tennessee, number 46, with the tackle. They have to bring the sticks in, but from this viewpoint, I think they made it, Tim.
Tight end offense. You see those Tennessee tackles slanting down to choke off that hole. Nice play by Williams. He's got a lot of quickness. Whenever you're playing with a fellow like Reggie White, who gets so much publicity, sometimes your good work goes unnoticed. And I think you mentioned earlier, Studaway has played well all year, and so has Johnny Williams.
5:07 to go, quarter number 1. Mississippi picks up their second first down, and they get some field position now. Out to their own 45, trailing Tennessee 7-0. First quarter from Neyland Stadium, Knoxville. Powell to throw on first down. There's a man there. Tennessee converges quickly and about 6 yards on the play for Buford McGee, Mississippi's leading receiver, Terry Brown with a tackle.
Kelly Powell really wanting the split end on that play. Linebackers doing an excellent job of underneath coverage for Tennessee, forced him to throw to the short man, McGee. This is the kind of offense that Mississippi wants to run. Little peck away at him a little bit, run the ball a little bit, keep it.
Mississippi gaining confidence in their offense their last three games, all of which they've won. There's the inside handoff, and Humphrey has broken it outside and down to the 29-yard line goes Arthur Humphrey. He is the junior fullback from Fort Walton Beach. He is a good straightaway runner.
You're going to just see some man-to-man blocking here as they all slam to the left, the offensive line. Humphrey, as he gets the ball, looks back to his right, looks for the cutback, and if the play is developed the way it's designed, this is what will happen. It'll break free all the way back to the weak side.
You saw 22, Charlie Davis, the Tennessee freshman free safety. Came in there to make the stop way downfield, but now Ole Miss threatening from the 29 of Tennessee. Number one defense in the SEC. Here comes McGee. Down he goes, but he struggled forward for about three more when he was hit at the line of scrimmage by 22, Charlie Davis. McGee, once again, is just been a very tough team leader by his performance at running back for Ole Miss this year. That hasn't always been the case, Tim. In 79, when he started, he got hurt. He was hurt again. Was redshirted in 80, got hurt again in 81. This year, he said his goal was to play all 11 games, and this is game number 10 for McGee. Second down seven. Incomplete over on the left side. Deming Moffitt with the intended receiver, Brown covering.
Kelly Powell started out the season as a second teamer. Played behind Ken Austin, who we saw last year set an NCAA record for most successive completions. He's playing, though, because of his leadership ability. Those offensive players really relate to him well, and they needed a blue-collar quarterback to come in there and be tough.
Five defensive backs in for the Volunteers. This is third down, seven, Ole Miss. A crucial conversion here. It's incomplete. Powell was under tremendous pressure back there. It was the Minister of Defense, number 92, Reggie White. Watch him work.
Now, White is originally, looks like somebody grabbing a hold of him a little bit there, John Allen. Originally, he was caught inside, fought his way through the lineman, get upfield to force Powell to fire that ball off. Good coverage by the Tennessee secondary.
Reggie White, number 92, is one of 12 nominees for the Lombardi Award, the Top College Lineman Award. He's a potential Outland Trophy winner. Some people are even talking Heisman. Here's a field goal attempt now. It'll be a long one by Neil Tevan. It's good. 43 yards for Neil Tevan, the longest of his young career. A sophomore walk-on. And now it's Tennessee 7 and Ole Miss 3. 2 minutes, 59 seconds to go in quarter number one. So Ole Miss drove it down the field and got a 43-yard field goal from Neil Tevan, a sophomore from Memphis who was a walk-on a couple of weeks ago when Bill Smith, who normally was kicking and punting, just really got worn out, the freshman kicker. And now it's a 7-3 game for Johnny Majors and his Volunteers with a 4-point lead. Just 2 minutes and 59 seconds to go in quarter number one. We're coming to you from Neyland Stadium in Knoxville, Tennessee. There you see your deep receivers going back for the University of Tennessee. The deep back is, and there's the kicker, number 7. He's a freshman. He kicks off. That is Bill Smith. The deep man for Tennessee, Randall Morris, number 12, leads the nation in kickoff returns with 31.8 yards per return. Let's see if he brings it out this time. Morris is going to let it go into the end zone. He was in some deep corner trouble. An outstanding kickoff on the part of Bill Smith there. He angled it into the end zone and didn't really give Morris a chance to get at it. So good job by that freshman. Now the Volunteers, leading 7-3, will come out on offense from their own 20-yard line. There's the scoring drive for Ole Miss.
Good balance there between the run and the pass and almost 5 minutes of possession. 3-for-4 with Kelly Powell.
With an audible, you see him turning and calling the play. Quick handoff to the fullback, Morris. He's apparently saw something in that Ole Miss defense he wanted to take advantage of. Got only a couple of yards out of it, however. And Cockrell has really come along in his maturation as a quarterback.
Yes. Paul Harris is really happy with his progress. Early, I think Allen was disappointed, and so are most of the Volunteer fans, but he is certainly, starting with that LSU game, made a lot of progress. He's making good decisions, good calls at the line of scrimmage, and displaying good leadership.
There's the time remaining in the first quarter. Second down, seven. Tennessee in a slot right formation. Cockrell rolls left.
And completes it to McGee, who is really hammered by number nine, Lee Davis.
First down pass reception to the 36-yard line for the Volunteers. Look at this hit again. I mean, this is a Tim Foley type tackle.
Bang. What they're doing is they're isolating the split end on the cornerback to the short side of the field, and they're just running individual patterns back there.
Tennessee runs it right up the gut with Sam Henderson. You can see that Tennessee has used three fullbacks already in this game. They started with freshman Jimmy Miller, came in with Sam Henderson, who's a truckload, 6'2", 245, more of a guard in terms of size than he is a running back, and Randall Morris, who was in on that other play. There's Henderson coming off. He was hurt in the Alabama game with his shoulder, but said in the papers here before the game today he wanted to take that shoulder in and see how it felt. Apparently it feels all right. Second down, five, Volunteers from the 41. And the tailback, Johnny Jones. Short of the first down to the 43-yard line.
That time, Allen Cockrell was already into his count when the Mississippi defense moved. Their line shifted. He came back out of the count, changed the play, and ran a new play. Mississippi's going to move a lot on defense and try to confuse this big play Tennessee offense.
Third down three for Cockrell and the Volunteers.
Get their hands up and knock it down. And Allen's going to pick a fight. He better find the defensive back.
Not one of the big boys. Here's Colquitt. Had a 48-yard punt first time out, averaging 42 and a half on the year. It's a pretty good one. Great coverage by Tennessee. Kemi Moffitt went down as soon as he caught the ball. 54 was Dale Jones, a freshman from Cleveland, Tennessee, who made the tackle for the Volunteers. Here, band, they'll be performing at halftime. Some scores. Look at this one. Halftime. What a battle in Tallahassee. Florida State over Miami at halftime. Michigan leading Minnesota. Greg Allen, by the way, scored that TD to bring Florida State back in that game. They were trailing 7-2, Tim.
Hurricanes are strong in the second half.
Don't know who to pull for there. We like both those teams. Going that time, Reggie White just plugged it up. Alvin Coles was there too. Howell just kept it. He may not be wanting to do that if he keeps getting hit like that.
I saw on Reggie White, why they're thinking about him for the Outland Trophy, Lombardi Trophy, and if you like the color orange, they're talking about a Heisman Trophy. He just covers a ton of ground for defensive linemen.
Second down nine, Ole Miss. Only 25 seconds remaining in the first quarter. It's 7-3, Tennessee leading. Here's Powell, last play of the first quarter. Big play, Powell didn't get the first down, but he gets it out to the 29-yard line. Kelly Powell has been very effective on conversion situations. That was only second down, I understand, but he's the kind of guy when he sees any kind of opening can make something out of it.
In that last drive, they ran the same pattern each time. It was to the weak side. This time, Powell is looking strong side. Tennessee has everyone covered. Now, that's like a quarterback run, right?
Not exactly a mobile quarterback, more of a pocket passer, and you see why. We'll be back with the second quarter in just a moment from Neyland Stadium, Knoxville, Tennessee, SEC football. The second quarter of tonight's game is brought to you in part by Chevrolet. Chevrolet is USA 1, and USA 1 is taking charge. And by Coors. Now the best of the Rockies is yours from the Adolph Coors Company, Golden, Colorado.
up with his third catch of the night. Zone. Once again, trying to get a first stretch on that defense. Putting players in three different levels. And that time he hit the tight end who was in between the halfback and the split end.
Now Dean Brown, 19, and 29 Andre Rogers with the wide receivers in for Ole Miss on a first and 10 from the 34. They hand it off to Humphreys. He tries the right side, gets across the 35 of the 36. Johnny Williams, Tennessee's middle guard, makes the stop. Tennessee with Studaway, Williams, and White up front. Coles and Zander, the middle linebackers, they're tough up the middle.
Mississippi would prefer to be on the right hash. That would have Reggie White into the sideline. That would give them the wide side of the field to operate to.
Five defensive backs in for Tennessee. Second down, 8, Ole Miss from the 36. Tennessee leading 7-3. We're early in the second quarter. Incomplete to Buford McGee. He's short of the first down, down to the 40. Needs about four more. It's going to be third down, 4 for the Rebels. That was Carl Zander, the left inside linebacker from Mendham, New Jersey, making the tackle for Volunteers.
Mississippi is tonight like a boxer. It's outweighed fighting a big puncher. They're just going to pick away, pick away, pick away, hoping they can stay in the game, hoping they can be there in the fourth quarter.
Third down, 4, Volunteers on defense. This is Ole Miss from the 40-yard line of the Rebels. Number one defense in the league. Doesn't stop the first down this time as Ole Miss goes to the tight end again. Number 91, Michael Smith, tackled by Joe Cofer. And Smith, with 4 catches on the night here, has now equaled his season total of catches coming into this, the 10th game of the year.
Well, Cofer has Smith man-to-man in this situation. Cofer's a converted linebacker. Vicious hitter. Occasionally has assignment problems, but he's a great athlete, and he's been a real improved player.
Off up the middle, only a couple of the yards. Arthur Humphrey carrying the ball. It was Williams with the tackle. There's Johnny Majors all dressed up in his warm orange, his big orange pink coat, I guess the best way to say it. I'd like to say to Johnny Majors, we appreciate all the fine hospitality and help that he's shown us here preparing for this ball game. Second down, 8, Ole Miss Rebels from the 48-yard line of Ole Miss. Powell keeps it on the option. Close, past the first down to the 40, and a penalty marker is down on the far side of the football field. Powell kept it, got the first down, Cofer with the tackle.
This time they run the option back into Reggie White. It's another part of their plan. They feel if they can option White, they know they're going to have a hard time blocking him. They got a face mask penalty there on Cofer coming over.
An Ole Miss now coming down here to the 35-yard line with a penalty that's added on. The referee is Bob Ayay.
Face mask, defense, unintentional, first down.
I think Bob Ayay found the off and on switch there on his microphone, and he's back at the ball game. We appreciate having him back in the booth with us now.
Yeah.
First down, 10, Ole Miss Rebels at the 35 of Tennessee. Volunteers lead 7-3, 12:15 to go, second quarter. Here's a pitch to McGee. Doesn't have the block. He's out of bounds at the line of scrimmage. Charlie Davis, the freshman from New York, the state of New York, New Paltz, and from Macon, Georgia, Terry Brown, another freshman, both combined to chase him out of bounds over there. Billy Brewer, first year head coach, Ole Miss.
Coaches make some decisions that are good and some that are bad. Billy Brewer's assembled a fine coaching staff, and one of the good things that Majors did was bring in Larry Marmee as a defensive coordinator who had been at North Carolina.
North Carolina could have used Larry today. They lost to Virginia, 17-14. Second down, 10, Ole Miss. Nickel back in for Tennessee. Powell throws anyway, right into the teeth of the defense, and it's complete near the 30-yard line. 85 freshman Steve Joyner from Branson, Mississippi.
Tennessee is all over that one. Powell does a nice job of sticking it in there between two defenders. I believe that's the fifth time that Smith has caught this pass. Now what's going to happen is those linebackers are going to start tucking up to take that ball away, and he'll hit Moffitt in behind it on the curl.
Here comes Kelly Powell, a charismatic leader. The words of Billy Brewer about his quarterback. Powell is a senior. Third and five.
Over the middle, it is complete. Down to the five-yard line. It's Joyner. Zander made the tackle. A 25-yard pass completion. And Ole Miss challenging for the lead in this game.
Charlie Davis is a little slow getting up, and they can ill afford to lose him. Same pattern. He works his way free here. Cooper is having a tough night right now. They seem to be working on him a little bit, the converted linebacker.
Ole Miss first and goal at the Tennessee 5. Tennessee, number one defense in the SEC, back to the wall. McGee to the 3. Cole Williams making the play down there, and Billy Brewer has the Ole Miss Rebels believing in themselves. He said he saw them come together in the last quarter of the loss to the University of Georgia. Georgia beat them 36-11, but they scored late. He says, I saw the team coming together. They've won 3 in a row. Second down goal. They spotted at the 4.
Number 87, Jamie Holder, a sophomore from Bay Springs, Mississippi.
Two wide receivers lined up to the wide side of the field. The outside man slanted in. The coverage back for Tennessee happened to run into the offensive receiver for Mississippi, which left Jamie Holder wide open.
Devan for the point after. It's good. It's the Ole Miss Rebs leading Tennessee in the Volunteers' backyard. 10-7, 10-17 to go, first half of play.
Well, Sam Bowie had 30 points in the blue and white scrimmage in Ashland, Kentucky, ready to go against the University of Louisville.
Sounds like he's doing pretty good.
Yes, he is. Right here on the superstation, Skip Carey and Joe Dean. And there's the young man who caught the threw the touchdown pass, Kelly Powell. And the man who caught it, Jamie Holder, is only 5'10".
Most people, if you're a defensive person, you would call that touchdown play a pick. If you're an offensive person, you'd just call it the defensive back running into an offensive receiver.
10-17 to go here in the first half. The kickoff goes in and out of the end zone. Volunteers will start at their own 20. Not accustomed to being behind here at Neyland Stadium. Over the years, Tennessee has won 80% of the games that they've played here. You can see that it's a little nippy in Knoxville, Tennessee tonight. Kim Foley would like to have a furnace like that up here in the booth, but fire marshals prohibit it. We see Tim on the sidelines, we'll know why. First down, 10 Volunteers from their own 20. They're trailing 10-7. Oh, there you see the left side. Kurt Singer jumped off as Cockrell was trying to call an audible. That'll be a 5-yard dead ball foul against Tennessee.
This will happen occasionally, calling a play at the line of scrimmage. It was probably, the ball was supposed to be snapped probably on the second sound. Singer not hearing what Cockrell was saying. Hit it downfield.
Illegal procedure. Offense. Still first down.
Last time Tennessee had the ball, they got themselves into trouble. Had a first down and 25. This time it's a first and 15. Let's see if they can dig themselves out of the hole they're in. It's complete, short of the first down. That was Tim McGee that's buried over there at the Ole Miss bench side, number 88, with the reception. Lee Davis, number 9, covering.
Excellent play. First down again, this time with first and 15, but Tennessee's got the ball in the air. Cockrell puts it on the money to McGee, and Lee Davis in good position there to make the hit.
Now Now it'll be second down three, Tennessee. McGee with five catches for 47 yards already.
Let's go, D. Come on, bring it.
Off the 27. Hand off to the tailback. That's Johnny Jones. First down to the 34. Tackle the number eight, Roger Clark. Johnny Jones, the leading rusher in the SEC, had 234 yards last week.
Great job by Streno there, walling off the nose guards, Mayo and Furness coming through. The last five games, as we mentioned previously, the Tennessee offensive line performing exceptionally.
Johnny Jones averaging 98.6 yards a game. And once again on the left side, looked like Singer jumped off.
You know, I think I know what's happening down there. And what's happening is the defense is checking off. Now, I don't know if they're going to call the defense for this. No, they're calling the offense. The defense is yelling, move. Singer thinks that's the snap count. He's taken off. He's not getting confused with the wordage. He's just getting confused with the noise. He's keyed himself to go on the next sound, and the defense moves the line, and he pops offside.
Story about Kurt Singer. He's a senior from Aliquippa, Pennsylvania. Very fiery young man, as Bob Allier, we hope, makes the announcement here if he can get his switch flipped on.
That's ball foul. Illegal procedure. Offense. Still first down.
And Kurt Singer is matched up at his left tackle position. He's 57 for Tennessee against number 80, Andre Townsend for Ole Miss, one of the great defensive tackles in this league. And he was so pumped up yesterday, he was angry even at our broadcast crew. He said, nothing personal, fellas, but I'm fired up.
Yeah. Cockrell was just talking to the referee, and I'm sure he was explaining the situation that's occurring on the field.
If the referee decides it's intentional, it could be a penalty against Ole Miss. He is detected. First down, 15 Volunteers, now from the 30. Johnny Jones, a tough runner. He's got speed, too, but he's a truckload when he turns the corner. It was Davis and Clark chasing him out of bounds. Let's watch Kurt Singer, 57, on this play. Against Townsend.
He knows the play is designed outside. He's supposed to wall off Townsend. Does a nice job of getting his head around Townsend. And that's a plus when they grade themselves in the movie.
Well, Kurt Singer saw two of those white shirt-clad Rebels go down. He ought to feel good about that. Second down eight. Penalty marker again. And folks, guess who jumped? If you guess Kurt Singer, you win a free trip up here to Knoxville.
Him moving a little bit early. They probably ought to just take him out for a play or two and let him get settled down. And here he comes off the field. He's their most consistent lineman. He's their best player. But right now, he's just upset, and he's not thinking well.
They sent in Bruce Wilkerson, a freshman from Philadelphia.
Head ball foul. Tennessee. Illegal procedure. Offense. Second down.
But that three times that penalty's been called against Singer here in Tennessee, and it's causing some problems. They're now second down 13 from their 32. Let's watch that left side now and watch number 68, Ziaida. Better in that area. Incomplete. Cockrell tried to throw it over the middle looking for his fullback, Randall Morris. Couldn't quite get turned around. Tennessee now in a third and 13 situation. The Volunteers are converting about 45% of their third downs coming into this game, and they're 2 out of 3 so far tonight. Sellout crowds, capacity house here tonight. We'll get an exact total for you. Capacity is around 92,000, but they often get 95 in here, and this is homecoming. There's the stats on Alan Cockrell as of right now. Excellent night for that young man so far. This is a big third down situation. Just had to throw it away. He was under pressure, could find no receivers. Bob Blakemore was back there pressuring him, number 88 for Ole Miss. Pass was intended for Henderson.
Nothing fancy there. 3-deep zone by Mississippi. Talking to Ron Case, the secondary coach for Mississippi, he said they just tried to simplify this thing and try to eliminate all the mental mistakes. Make it easy so nobody beats themselves.
Interesting situation for Ole Miss. They have twin punt receivers back there. Usually there's just one back there. Let's see. That's going to be Moffitt who takes it. Out here to the 31-yard line goes Tim Moffitt. He's tackled by 54. Dale Jones, his second play on special teams tonight.
John
Smokey, the Blue Tick Hound, Tennessee's mascot. Smokey Mountains just outside of Knoxville. Time left in the first half. It's Ole Miss 10, Tennessee 7. Rebels ball, first and 10 from their 31. That's Humphreys, the fullback. He's putting himself some yardage on the board as he runs out here to the 41-yard line, close to a first down. Humphrey now has 37 yards on the night.
Just straight ahead, side blocking as they reach. They double the first down lineman, and one of those linemen should come off and try to pick up the linebacker. Humphrey hits the hole. What they try to do in that situation is line up a little bit wider, get bigger splits, they call it, bigger distance between the offensive linemen, and stretch out those defenders, and then just run straight ahead right at them, let the fullback pick his hole.
See, they didn't quite get that first down, but it's going to be very short here. It'll be second down in inches, and often, Tim, as we've seen time and time again, this is a kind of a free play in the minds of the offense. They have a free one coming.
Right. It's a time when you might expect them to try to go up top.
They're just going to get the first down by giving it to Humphreys. They do, out to the 43, Tony Williams with a tackle.
I think you're going to see Larry Marmy, the defensive coordinator for these Tennessee Volunteers, begin to blitz Cole or Xander in that guard tackle gap a little bit, try to create some pressure, try to throw off the timing. Right now they're just kind of laying back.
Coles, by the way, is number 44, the right inside linebacker, a former fullback, and Xander's 45, the left inside linebacker. They're very fine linebackers. Attack, first and 10, Ole Miss.
It's complete to the 42-yard line of Tennessee. The receiver is Timmy Moffitt, number 30, second leading receiver on this team, and a big clutch pass receiver for the Rebels.
Across your screen. This time he pumps the tight end and throws it to the slot receiver who has turned out. And Moffitt has done an exceptional job this year of picking up the load that was left him by the injury of James Harbor.
16 covering on the play with Tommy Sims for Tennessee. On the first down, pitch to McGee. The penalty marker goes down before the ball was snapped. By the way, those great replays that you see tonight from the tape replay, tip the hat to Skip Ellison down there doing a good job, and he's working under really difficult conditions, as are several of the members of our Atlanta-based crew. As Auburn defeated the Bulldogs today, so everybody's talking very quietly to Skip and Rowan and several of the fellas.
I thought you were going to say it was difficult because they're working with us.
Well, that too.
That's all foul. Illegal procedure. Offense, still first down.
By the way, just tell you, Tim, so you can get in the same funk that some of the crews in your alma mater Purdue was also.
I'm getting used to it, though. The poor Boilers.
On a first and 15, Ole Miss. Howell. It's complete to Humphreys. He's out to the about 42-yard line of Tennessee. Our producer, Mike Lardner's alma mater, Boston College, upset by Syracuse today. So Mike's in a bad mood, but they're working on anyway. The professionalism remains the same, and our hats are tipped to the crew.
And we talked about Moffitt. James Harbor was their speed man and really their best receiver. And he went down in 2-a-days this summer during summer practice. And Moffitt had to really come on and pick up a heavy load. And he's done a good job for him. And he's been their most consistent receiver.
Five defensive backs in there for Tennessee. Second down, four Ole Miss. Penalty markers everywhere. Apparently, again, before the ball was snapped. Second down, nine is the call. 7 minutes to go here in the first half. Illegal procedure is the call. And Greg Walker, 74. Let's see if it was Walker, number 74 on the right side for Ole Miss. There you go. He's the man. Interestingly enough, he's playing against Tennessee's big defensive tackle, Reggie White. So the offensive lineman for Tennessee against Townsend having trouble, and the same thing for Walker against Tennessee's White.
Illegal procedure. Offense. Second down.
By the way, Tim, Greg Walker's a converted tight end.
Converted tight end, and he played against Alabama after only 4 days of practice at tight end. There's a penalty comparison there.
Only weighs 235 pounds. They say only. That's very light for an offensive tackle. Here's Howell.
It's caught at the 25.
on the road. Mississippi is really, I think they're probably at this point performing beyond their expectations.
Ole Miss has called timeout. Kelly Powell's coming to the sideline. You can see those fellas are happy about it. We'll be back.
When it comes time to kick up your heels.
Again, they lead 10-7. 6:42 to go, first half. First down goal. This is McGee, number 10. Down to the one-yard line. Charles Benton, number 20, with a tackle for the Volunteers.
See it from our end zone camera. They're trying to take this play outside. There's Williams pursuing Zander, trying to run through. And watch McGee turn it up there. Great hit by number 20, Charles Benton, keeps him out of the end zone.
Lead ball is right on the right side hash mark, 1 yard line. Second down goal, Ole Miss. Full house, back people. McGee, hit behind the line of scrimmage. May have gotten back 2-1, not much more. Robbie Scott, a freshman, middle guard.
Perfect goal line defense. Scott grabbed through there and then come up, get his head up and make contact. Fine play by the freshman defensive lineman.
Tennessee, number 1 in total defense in the SEC. Number 3 against the rush. Number 2 against the score. Only 3 rushing touchdowns all year for Tennessee. Third and goal, Ole Miss. Powell. Incomplete. Oh, this Volunteer defense is tough when they have their backs against the wall.
Credit Dale Jones, who was covering the tight end, and Charles Benton, who was covering the back in the flat for preventing a touchdown. They fake the run. Good call. Roll to the outside. Benton is covering the lead back. Jones scrambling to try to get to the tight end. Powell really has no one to throw the ball to.
Tim, Ole Miss has called timeout again. Kelly Powell is over to talk to. You see the blonde-headed fellow in the middle. That's Billy Brewer, the first-year Ole Miss coach, coaching at his alma mater. He came here from Louisiana Tech. Before that, southeastern Louisiana. They're going to go for it on fourth down from the 2, I believe.
Well, if they can come up with something that excites them, I think they'll go for it. They need to take advantage of every scoring opportunity that they get. We talked about Tennessee's defense. Well, Mississippi's offense is rated last in the SEC. You know, they have not been as productive as Brewer would like them to be, but they are on the rise. He's got them going now. He's got them believing in themselves. He's got them believing that they can win, and that's just something that they had to overcome.
Well, they have that 3-game win streak. They scored 20 points to beat TCU, 21 points to beat Vanderbilt, and 27 to beat LSU. As you can see, they're scoring more points in every game, but Tennessee allows only 13 points a game, so they've got 10 now. Okay, let's see what they're going to try. Ole Miss Rebels, fourth and goal from the 2 of Tennessee. 5:19 to go, second quarter. It's 10-7. Ole Miss leading. Tennessee's defense digs in.
Tried the quarterback sneak. Jones closed the gap. Excellent play by the freshman Dale Jones. He's really fought his way into a starting spot. He was excited.
Oh, they're watching in Cleveland, Tennessee, and they're bringing a dancer right now. You can bet on that. First and 10, Tennessee, but they're in their own end zone. Don't get but just a little bit as they try to hand it off to Sam Henderson, the fullback. Kerry Williamson, nose guard for Ole Miss with a tackle. The Tennessee kept the Rebels out of the end zone, but of course now this Rebel defense, which is not bad themselves, has got the Volunteers huddling. They're back to the wall.
An unusual call by Mississippi. 2 yards to go on the goal line, a quarterback sneak. But they must have seen something during the week in the film that they thought they could take advantage of.
There's the Volunteer view. 5 yard line goes tailback Johnny Jones. Tennessee's got that short yardage offense in there. They want to be conservative. What they do not want is to turn the ball over. Even if they don't get a first down here, they have Jimmy Colquitt, who's their outstanding punter, they can bring in to try to dig themselves out of the hole. There's the story on the time, 4:25 to go in the first half. We've got ourselves a fine football game.
Duncan and Taylor Morris are into the game, all receivers. This is a time when you can throw the ball down the field. If it's intercepted, it's not going to be any worse than a punt for you. You've got a chance to get an interference call or get somebody open.
Third down, 8. Cockrell's going to throw it downfield.
To the sideline, incomplete, intended for 24, Clyde Duncan.
And Colquitt's going to have to come in and punt as we take a look at Duncan once again. Split in for Tennessee.
Duncan moving down the field. Breaks it off, gets his head and shoulders around. Excellent position by Lee Davis. Perfect body control as he saw the ball being thrown, broke, and was in great shape to make the interception as the ball has been on the money.
Colquitt is in for his fourth punt of the night with the Volunteers, averaging 46.5 on the night. He punts out of his end zone. He is a great clutch punter. Not this time. It's a poor punt by Colquitt Sanders. That's Moffitt. At the 41, Colquitt is aided by great punt coverage by the Volunteers. Only a 38-yarder from his end zone. Sam Henderson with the tackle for Tennessee. From Legion Field in Birmingham. And for the Hall of Fame Bowl, Dr. Harvey Coker is right here in Tennessee tonight. Ole Miss first down 10. This is McGee. From behind, number 45, Carl Zander, gets his sixth tackle of the night for the Volunteers. Old meat and potatoes.
As we mentioned, I felt they would start to try to get pressure up through the middle. This time, Zander runs through from his linebacker position, makes a play behind the line of scrimmage. The defense for Tennessee, I think you'll see them start to play more aggressively now.
It looks as though Mississippi's trying to run away from defensive left tackle Reggie White. Let's see. Second down, 9. Incomplete. Intended for 81, Michael Smith, the tight end. Out at the 35-yard line. Joe Cooper covering on the play, bringing up third down.
That's there. One for Joe. There he is. They've been working on Joe a little bit. I don't think it's so much they're working on him, but they've just been trying to get the ball to the tight end in their zone schemes, and Joe has been close a lot, but Joe did a nice job of coverage on that play. And I would agree. Billy Brewer seemed like a pretty sane person to me. If I was him, I'd run away from Reggie White, too.
He said today, he says, Bob, we don't like to disrupt our offensive scheme and run away from anybody, but we don't want to run Reggie White necessarily. Third down conversion situation. Complete out of bounds at the 25. Moffitt caught it and was driven out of the boundary before he came down. And of course, that's a completely legal and an excellent defensive play by Tennessee.
Powell dropping the throw, looking to his split end the whole way. Ball just led Moffitt a little bit too much. Couldn't get his feet down. Brown there in good position.
Great sideline view for our CBS camera, our cart cameraman, by the way, tonight, Rick Rafers. Little nippy and chilly on the field. Smith with the punt, just barely got it away. Tim McGee, 88, back to take it. Going to let it go into the end zone. The wingman is actually the fellow who was chasing it there. That was Dean Brown of Ole Miss, but it was a 41-yard punt, a touchback, and out it'll come. Michigan beating Minnesota. Well, at least Bob Neal's happy. 31-3 in the second quarter. And look at this. What a ball game at Tallahassee. 16-14. Bobby Bowden. Seminoles are leading Snellenberger's Hurricanes. Tim Foley, I don't know who to pull for there. It's just an interesting game.
Great coaches. A couple of great coaches. And Howard Snellenberger obviously is up for a lot of Coach of the Year awards if he could pull that game off and take his team to the Orange Bowl.
On a first down, 10, Tennessee, from the 20, Cockrell.
It's picked off. Number 8 is Roger Clark. He has some blocks. Out of bounds at the 15-yard line, Mike Furness with the tackle. And oh, boy, Ole Miss is challenging the Volunteers.
Tennessee throwing the football. It's kind of a dangerous throw. Cockrell overthrows Taylor, hits Clark in the chest. Clark makes all the defensive adjustments for that Mississippi secondary. Very intelligent player with good field sense, was in the right place at the right time then.
26-yard interception return. 2:40 to go in the half. Ole Miss leads 10-7 on first down. Powell completes with a 6. 3-7 to Michael Smith, the tight end. They got to go to the 4-yard line for the first down. So Tennessee's defensive unit comes up with a very, very big goal line stand. As they try to get the ball out of there, they stop Ole Miss again. Tennessee comes back, and now they've got their back to the wall again.
Very discouraging defensively. John Majors got to be concerned now.
Second down, 3 Rebels at the 7 of Tennessee. 2 minutes to go, first half. Rebels lead 10-7. Powell. Oh, he's hit hard. Oh, and you know who that was? 92, Reggie White. You see 54 getting up, but it was Reggie White who made the initial contact.
Powell coming with the option. White slipped all the way underneath the block of the tackle to come up there and make that play. Watch him move to the inside, hit the inside gap. Somebody's going to have to cut him off. I think they're expecting White to be farther outside, and they're probably going to try to option him.
That's what the coach is saying on the sideline. Are there any volunteers to step in here, Ole Miss, to stop Reggie White? Third down, 6, Ole Miss. They're still threatening here, though. Powell, time. Into the end zone, incomplete, right at the post. Number 14 covering is Terry Brown. Jimmy Moffitt was the man for whom the pass was intended. Locked down to 1:18, and we'll probably have a field goal attempt here. I see number 92, Neil Sevan, putting his knee down at the 17-yard line. It'll be a 27-yard field goal attempt for Sevan. Coming up at halftime, which is just 1:18 away, our making of an All-American team, sponsored by Chevrolet, the Ole Miss Rebel Marching Band, Tennessee's band, football action report, CNN headline news, the action halftime highlight. Field goal attempt is good, and it's Ole Miss 13, Tennessee 7. Now remember, Tennessee leads the conference in scoring, a second in the conference. Scoring defense, averaging only 13 points a game. And Mississippi has them.
Mississippi game plan obviously working. Billy Brewer has to be excited at this point about the progress of his football team. Tennessee with a great group of defensive coaches. Katavlis in the secondary, and Shaw and Sweatman and Larry Marmee, the defensive coordinator, will be sure to make some adjustments at halftime.
However, we need to give some accolades to the UT defense for having a couple of good goal line stands. But out of the middle of the field, you're right, Tim Foley. Ole Miss moving the ball pretty well.
In the run and the pass, and basically they've made all their yardage with one pattern. And Powell has done a nice job of finding the open receiver and just putting the ball in there.
Bill Smith is the man who kicked off for Ole Miss. He's number 7, freshman kicker. And the deep back for Tennessee, Randall Morris. As I told you earlier, Morris, number 12 for Tennessee, leads the nation in kickoff return.
They'd like to hear from him right now.
He gets his kick. Almost, but not quite. Out to the 22-yard line comes Randall Morris. That was about a 24-yard return, roughly, based on my own estimation there. At 6 to go in the halftime, it's Mississippi 13, Tennessee 7. There's Randall Morris. He's playing a little bit hurt, too. Randall Morris hurt his knee in a game against Georgia Tech. They call him Too Hard to Handle Randall.
The last time we saw him, he was too hard to handle against LSU. Had a fine night running the football.
Volunteers with 6 left in the half. Tennessee has all 3 of their timeouts left if they want to use them. That's Johnny Jones out here at the 23-yard line. 58-57, clock ticking down in the first half of play from Neyland Stadium, Knoxville, Tennessee. Temperatures down to about 37 or 38 degrees here. A cold night in Knoxville. It's the first nighttime homecoming game Tennessee's ever had. They wondered if all the old alums and students would be here. Well, of course they are. To complete to Duncan. Penalty marker down. Duncan down at the... He goes out of bounds, actually, at the 37. He went down at the 40. Eric Truitt with the play, but a penalty marker went down right at the point of reception.
I think they may call Lenny Taylor for blocking downfield while the ball was in the air.
They're calling the penalty against Tennessee.
You see the secondary here for Mississippi. And they ran this quick screen for an 80-yard gain against Alabama. It's the type of play that's a conservative play, but it can pop. And you saw Lenny Taylor right at the top of your screen blocking as the ball was in the air. And he knows from back at Southridge High School he can't do that.
Move it back to the 11-yard line.
Offensive pass interference. Second down. Loss of down. Third down.
There's the whole story from Bob Aye, the referee tonight, the most experienced official in the Southeastern Conference working this very big football game tonight. There's a timeout on the field. Tennessee called it. There's 33 seconds left, and I'm sure that Alan Cockrell and Johnny Majors are going to get together and just decide whether they want to gamble or just be conservative here as they're trailing 13-7 with 33 seconds left. This telecast is authorized under broadcasting rights granted by the National Collegiate Athletic Association and is intended solely for the entertainment of our audience. Any publication, rebroadcast, retransmission, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, or accounts of this game in whole or in part without the express written consent of the NCAA and WPBS-TV is prohibited. The announcers for the event are employed by the Turner Broadcasting System Incorporated and just happen to be yours truly, Bob Neal, and my good friend, Ken Foley. There's Johnny Majors. Johnny Majors introduced Tim and I to his team as they warmed up yesterday, and Tim had a little short joke about his old friend George Catavilis, the defensive backfield coach that broke up this entire Volunteer squad, Tim. You know something I don't know.
No, you have to know George to get it. But George has done an exceptional job here. This secondary for Tennessee is just buying man-to-man coverage people, and they get up into the support quickly.
Number two in the league in pass defense. Tennessee is running the ball out here across the 16-yard line. Goes Randall Morris. Andre Townsend with the tackle. Brought down to 25, 24, and counting down. Tennessee's used another timeout, and Cockrell's coming over to the sideline again to talk once again to the offensive folks. No, this time Ole Miss is calling the timeout. As it's going to be fourth down for Tennessee, and Ole Miss has still got 20 seconds. You talk about believing in themselves, they're going to try to go at it again.
Well, right now, Tennessee is in a situation where they're lucky it's only 13-7. Mississippi has performed beyond expectations, and Tennessee appeared to be a little flat. Whenever you're going into a game that you're supposed to win by 14 points, and you've been through some dog fights, and you've beat some powers like Alabama, it's a little bit tougher to get up for a game like this, and it takes a mature team that's really used to winning consistently to do it. And that's what Johnny Majors is trying to establish here, and he certainly has them going in the right direction.
There's Colquitt in the punt as you look at Billy Brewer, his team leading 13-7 at halftime with 20 seconds remaining. Now here are double punt receivers once again, Tim, as we mentioned, kind of interesting, Wilbert and Moffitt.
It gives you a couple options back there. The man that doesn't catch the ball is responsible for picking off the first coverage man downfield.
And he just did that. 27 is Wilburn with the ball. He only goes out to the 44. Clock goes down to 9 seconds remaining. Penalty marker is on the field again. Jim Duncan with the tackle for Tennessee. That was a 46-yard punt by Coles at that time. Blocking, as you can see, below the weight, an open field on punt or kick returns is illegal, and that's going to be the call against Ole Miss. It'll put them back quite a ways. They'll mark it back to the 29-yard line, where Ole Miss will have only 9 seconds. They have no timeout remaining.
Blocking below the waist, on the run back, first down.
Rebels at the line of scrimmage from the 29. They hand it off to Humphrey, runs it up the middle. The clock goes down to 4, to 3, to 2, and it'll tick right out, ending the first half of play. A surprising first half. The Ole Miss Rebels have come in here to Tennessee's home turf, Neyland Stadium, at homecoming 1983, and the Rebels are leading 13-7. We have a lot of halftime highlights.
highlights and scores, including highlights of that Florida State-Miami game. Stay with us for halftime. There are the first half statistics in this ball game between Ole Miss and Tennessee. As you can see, Ole Miss dominating control of the ball nearly 20 minutes to just over 10 minutes. And Tim, as you said, the game plan working very well for the Rebels. They just dominate all the way in passing, total yards, everything.
The Rebels have won every time they've been able to contain the opposition offense to 300 yards or less. And they're certainly on track here tonight.
Neyland Stadium, homecoming 1983, Johnny Majors, who played some great football here in the 50s. Bowden Wyatt was his head coach. He was talking about him on the sidelines yesterday. Johnny Majors was a runner-up in 56 for the Heisman Trophy to guess who? A friend of mine, played for Notre Dame, Paul Rooney.
The only man to win the Heisman Trophy with a on a team with a losing record, right?
Johnny Majors, just one of a long line of great tailbacks. Johnny Majors, by the way, was also punter for Tennessee that year.
And speaking of 1956, the SID at Notre Dame then was a fellow named Charlie Callahan, who was also with the Dolphins for a long period of time.
Randall Morris is going to let the ball go out of bounds, and that'll be a five-yard penalty against the Ole Miss Rebels. But you can't really criticize Bill Smith, their freshman kicker, because he's trying to kick away from the nation's leading kickoff returner. And one time earlier in the first half, he kicked it out of bounds in that coffin corner. And to kick off into the coffin corner is a feat indeed. He almost did it that time. He's a straight-ahead kicker as he laces up again. I always get a kick out of watching the conventional-style kickers go through their mechanical. It's a real exercise in physics and engineering there. Bill Smith is a freshman from Little Rock, Arkansas. He can punt, kick, field goal, kick off. Now he's just kicking off and punting as they have an outstanding walk-on short-range field goal kicker, Neil Sivan, who has a couple of field goals here tonight for Ole Miss in the first half. Goal from the 35 will do it all over again. This is going to give an opportunity to Randall Morris. Too hard to handle Randall from the 10. To the 33-yard line. Ole Miss covering well on that play. And the Volunteers trailing 13-7. Come out here with 14:53 to go in the third quarter. Opening seconds of play. The Neyland Stadium in Knoxville. There you see some of the 90,000-plus that are on hand for homecoming crowd.
They've got the big fella, John Matthews, in at tight end, Bob, which indicates to me that they're going to run the football a little bit.
Hand off to the fullback, out to the 37-yard line. That's big Sam Henderson carrying the ball. As Tim told you, Tennessee wants to start getting something going on the ground so they can loose it up for the air, if anything else. Sam Henderson, 6'2", 245, that fullback, is really a truckload. He hurt his shoulder against Alabama. But it's pretty well healed now. He comes out, another fullback goes in. This time it's Kenneth B.B. Cooper. He's the other way. He's only 5'6". Cooper, number 30, front man in the eye. Pitch to the tailback. That's Randall Morris. Out here at the 44-yard line, first down, tackled by Roger Clark.
The offensive line play. You see Singer there, working on the defensive tackle there. I thought it was Townsend, but it wasn't. I think it was Blakemore. Nice job by Kurt Singer.
First down 10, Tennessee, from the 44-yard line. Here comes Randall Morris trying the other side. Not as much success. Joe Hall, number 3, tripped up the ball carrier. Last man into the play, you saw Terry Williams diving over there and finishing him off. Gain on the play of about 3 yards for Tennessee.
Alan Cockrell trying to generate some offense for the Tennessee Volunteers. Joe Hall on the tackle. Joe is the emotional leader of that Mississippi defense. He just plays. He's one of those folks that plays full speed on every play.
Nellie Powell putting up a lot of stats way ahead of Cockrell. Cockrell calls it audible at the line of scrimmage. Second down 8. Comes Morris again. Close to the first down. He gets inside Ole Miss territory, but probably going to be about a yard short. To the 48-yard line goes Randall Morris. It was Blake Boren Hubbard with the tackle. Looks like a lot of effort went into the punt.
Terry Williamson, the nose man there, Blake Moore. It looks like Tennessee is directing some of its offensive attack away from Andre Townsend. Also a good idea. He's a dominating lineman in Mississippi defense. Right now, they're running away from him.
On a third down conversion situation, full house backfield. Third down two, Tennessee, double tight end. Play fake, Cockrell's going to keep it. He's short of the first down. Knifing in to make the tackle, number 50, Lee Cole from Laurel, Mississippi.
Mississippi does an excellent job here, moving laterally down the line of scrimmage. Linebacker taking a chance, running through and making the stop of Cockrell before he could throw it.
So it's going to be fourth down. Tennessee's Johnny Majors has decided to go for it. Same offensive alignment. Fourth down and less than a yard from the 46-and-a-half-yard line. Henderson, I believe, got it. They're going to say his forward progress got to about the 45-and-a-half. So it'll be a first down for Tennessee unless they have a very unusual mark of the ball.
They're running over Bill Mayo and Steve Knight there driving off the ball. John Cook, the tight end. Little B.B. Cooper leading the way into the hole.
First down, Tennessee, just outside the 45-yard line of Ole Miss. Ole Miss brings us on the sideline. Coach is looking on as their defense tries to stop the Volunteers, who penetrated Ole Miss territory, and even more, Randall Morris goes to the 37-yard line. And as Tim Foley told you at the beginning of this half, he expected Tennessee to come out here running, and run they are.
Bill Mayo doing a nice job on Thomas Hubbard. You're going to be able to see number 67. Swinging around the center there, Glenn Streno, occupying that linebacker, giving room to the running back.
Bill Mayo from Dalton, Georgia, very personable young man. His folks are watching on the cable tonight. Hand off over on the right side, close to the first down. I think they got it by, again, about half the length of the fullback. That was Sam Henderson carrying. Half the length of the football, the fullback was carrying, and Dwight Bingham made the stop. Alan Cockrell, he's become quite the leader here at Tennessee. He injured his leg in 1981, and he got a bad rap about losing his mobility. He had to overcome that in that rap in the minds of a lot of folks.
Yeah, he's had some knee problems over the course of his career. He certainly has regained his agility, moves well in the pocket.
First down, 10 Volunteers at the 35 of Ole Miss to the tailback, Morris. He slams it in there to the 29-yard line of the Rebels. Thomas Hubbard, senior linebacker from Birmingham, Alabama. They call him Big Hub with a stop that time. He's number 37 for Ole Miss.
I think initially Walt Harris wanted the offensive coordinator for Tennessee. He wanted to try some things out, wanted to show that they could throw the ball to the outside. But in the first half, they weren't able to establish anything, any consistency, and now they're just going back to hard nose. Here we come.
Second down five, UP from the 30. Jackson and I, receivers split wide left and right. More audibles from Cockrell. Randall Morris tries it off the right side. Morris does not get the first down. He doesn't get much at all. Terry Williamson, the junior nose guard from Montauk, Mississippi, with the stop.
There you see Mike Furness pulling, moving down along the line, probably the fastest lineman for Tennessee, leading the way. Streno watching. Johnny Majors now he's starting to check on what's being called. He can hear the play coming down. He usually doesn't have a lot of input or interference, but he can hear what's going on.
Tennessee only 2 out of 7 on third down conversion. They pitch to Morris. A lot of running room. First down, Volunteers for the 24. It was Roger Clark, the free safety for the Rebels with a tackle. This crowd coming to life at Neyland Stadium. They haven't had much to cheer about. Volunteers trailing 13-7, 9:33 to go, third quarter at the sellout homecoming crowd. And now the Volunteers threatening again. Great end zone shot here, the first down play for the Volunteers. Cockrell, audible. Gives to the fullback. Not much going on the play. That's Sam Henderson. Thought he saw something up the middle, but obviously didn't, as the Ole Miss defense collapses on him.
Freddie not making contact here. Coming from his outside linebacker position. Drills the fullback, Sam Henderson. Cockrell calls a lot of plays from the line of scrimmage. Mississippi presents a problem in that they move their defense a lot. See what happens here.
Second down, 8 from the 23-yard line.
Randall Morris. Oh, what great move he had. First down. Morris to the 8-yard line. Barry Wilburn with the tackle.
Roger Clark there, number 8, number 37, Thomas Hubbard. An excellent job of blocking up front. Lee Cole being taken out of the play. Morris Knight for the goal line on the 8-yard line. Billy Brewer, a little concerned now.
He says of this defensive unit, they've got grit, fit, and they never quit. Let's see how they do. With their backs to the wall. First and goal, Volunteers. Full house backfield, double tight end. They hand it off to Henderson. He gets only to the 7-yard line. It was number 80, Andre Townsend, with the stop.
Just for your replay of the line here, Andre Townsend down in the left corner of your screen. Nice to the inside. Makes the play on the fullback, Sam Henderson. He's a leader in there. He's the strength of the offensive line. He's got 8 sacks. He's a fine, fine athlete.
It was over 500 pounds of manhood. Townsend at 265 and Henderson at 245. Pitch back to Morris. He slips and falls at the 8. And it looked as though a hole was about to happen. It was second down and goal from the 7.
It did look like they have a little room there as you see. Cockrell calls, caught the ball back to Morris. He just loses his footing on the turf. Taylor coming into the game now. Duncan into the game. We're going to get in a passing situation.
It's third down goal from the 7-yard line. Rebels leading Volunteers 13-7. Tennessee ball third quarter. Cockrell. Incomplete at the goal line. He was trying to find number 2, Lenny Taylor. Good defensive coverage by the Ole Miss Rebels number 9, Lee Davis, who's been playing great as of late.
Lee Davis has excellent feet and quickness and reacts well to the football. They come with the same play that they scored on early in the first quarter. This time Mississippi picks it up. Their defensive backs stick with their assigned people. They can't fit it in.
It's going to be a 25-yard field goal attempt on fourth down by Fuad Ravaez, junior from Miami, Florida. 13 out of 21 on field goals this year. This one is good. Penalty marker is down. Ravaez was hit after he kicked it by Ole Miss number 3, Joe Hall. It could be new life for Tennessee. Ravaez is happy that they're going to take his 3 off the board. If that, in fact, is the call, here's Bob Aye with the call. Roughing the kicker against Ole Miss.
Really see who hit him.
Now they're talking down there on the side. The officials are talking about exactly what did happen and when it happened. Billy Brewer looks on.
I didn't see him get hit. Did you see him get hit?
As a matter of fact, that's probably what they're talking about. It looked as though he got just barely clipped by number 3, Hall. Let's watch and see.
Running into the kicker. Refuse. Be assessed on the kickoff.
Here's the reason. Running into the kicker is only 5-yard penalty. It was fourth down, so the ball would have gone over to Ole Miss. Thereby, Tennessee had no choice but to take the field goal and the 3 points. Roughing the kicker, had he been hit harder, would have been an automatic first down. And we'll be right back. All right, there it is again. You see number 3, Joe Hall, running into number 4, Fuad Ravaez, hitting him in the right shoulder. Ravaez with an Oscar-winning performance. And, Tim, you know, this year he could be penalized for acting out a fake, but the official apparently felt he wasn't acting. Looked like acting to me. Nevertheless, the field goal stands at 13-10. Kickoff deep into the end zone by Ravaez. Lee Davis is just going to touch it down there. So we've got ourselves a 13-10 ball game, and while we were away, you saw coming back that Miami with a great come-from-behind victory over FSU.
How is Schellenberger taking his Hurricanes to the Orange Bowl? I'm sure he'll be nominated for many Coach of the Year awards. Certainly he's going to be talked about for the TBS Coach of the Year award.
.35 to go, third quarter. Mississippi 13, Tennessee 10. Powell flips to McGee. Finds about 3 or 4 yards of running room, and that's all. He is tackled by number 46, Johnny Williams.
Arthur Humphrey threw a nice block out in front of that option. Allowed them to gain any yardage at all.
This is the first time Ole Miss has had the ball. Tennessee had the ball the entire third quarter up till now. There's only 6 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Second down, 6 from the 24. Toss to McGee. He has running room on the outside. Oh, he turned it back inside. Got the first down out to the 31. Penalty marker is down. Cooper with the tackle. It looked from our vantage point up here, and when I say up here at Neyland Stadium, Tim Bowie and I are 11 floors above the ground.
They're going to call Steve Cunningham for holding on that play. He was running at the fullback position. Their method for neutralizing Reggie White will be running the option at him. As you saw, Reggie White ended up having to take the quarterback on the option. We're going to see this again.
Here's the call from the official Bobby Yates first.
Offense.
Okay, and here it is again.
Isolation on White. Offensively, they're thinking like this. They're looking at that like the quarterback is blocking Reggie White, taking him out of the play, and that's a matchup they'll take all night long.
All right, this time it is second down 10, Ole Miss, from their own 20-yard line. Powell, over the middle, it's complete to Humphrey, the fullback, short of the first down, out to the 28-yard line. Carl Zander with the tackle, his eighth of the night.
One thing they must have decided at halftime is that the tight end isn't going to catch many balls for Mississippi. They were all over Michael Smith that time. He wasn't there. The foul came off Smith and got the ball to Humphrey.
Now it is third down 3, Ole Miss, from the 27.5-yard line. Big conversion situation. And contact there between the center, 57 Pierce, and the nose guard, 46 Johnny Williams.
Offside Tennessee. In the replay, watch the ball. Oop. Occasionally, what an offensive football team will do will come to the line of scrimmage and just bark out signals, and they've got nothing called. Mississippi has done this in the past, and it looked like that time they were just waiting to jump.
Ball. Offside defense. First down.
Get some movement on the defensive line, and then the center snapped the ball.
Time remaining. The third quarter of play from Neyland Stadium in Knoxville. It's Ole Miss 13, Tennessee 10. Great SEC ball game here. Big game for both schools. Powell has his man open. That's Joyner out to the 36-yard line. Gain of about 5. Sims with a tackle for the Volunteers.
That same zone pattern. The split end is coming down the field and curling at about 13 yards. Tight end dragging across the field in front of the linebackers and the cornerback.
Powell now, by the way, is 15 out of 23 for 149 yards and one TD. The most yardage that he's passed for this year since he came into that Vanderbilt game. Second down 6, Ole Miss from the 36-yard line. Powell on the option. Crosses. McGee. Great pursuit by Tennessee. Very little, if any, gain. Free safety freshman Charlie Davis with a tackle.
We'll watch the secondary. George Katopoulos' secondary pursue here. And this is what stops an option. He's got to get those defensive backs up into the play. Look at Davis coming right to the middle of your screen there. And up at the top of the screen is Davis. In the middle of the screen is Vince Clark. All getting into the play, getting into the action.
Third down. Defensive it back then for Tennessee. Powell is going to throw it. Had a man open in the seam of the Tennessee defensive zone. It was 87 Holder, but Powell overthrew it out of bounds. They don't convert. Now Ole Miss will have to punt the ball away, leading Tennessee 13-10, 3:29 to go, third quarter.
That ball was intended for Jamie Holder, and he was a walk-on at Mississippi. He wrote Steve Sloan in a letter, asked if he could try out. He wasn't expecting to see much play this early in his career, but he caught 9 balls earlier in the season. Doing a real fine job for him at flanker.
Bill Smith gets off an end-over-end punt to the 31-yard line of Tennessee. He had been averaging 46 yards a punt coming up to that one. That punt was only 32 yards.
Shot for shot, tread the thin, muffler's gone.
Well, come on in, get more for your life.
You change your tires, take your aim, move out to ride and catch the game.
There's more for your life, for the times of your life. There's more for your life.
Hey, let me bum a chew you, beef, sir.
Now you don't like that balanced taste.
Balanced?
Uh-huh.
What?
Some chewing tobacco leads to the sweet side, while others lead to the hard side. Bite. My beef nuts got balance taste. Just right.
Give me some of that balance taste. I'm tired of traveling.
Balance taste. That's beef nut red and refreshing wintergreen.
The Southeastern Conference is privileged to have 10 outstanding football coaches, including 8 who also played in the SEC and 5 who've returned to their alma maters to coach. And tonight you're seeing 2 of those alumni. Tennessee's Johnny Majors and Billy Brewer of Ole Miss. The preceding message provided by the Southeastern Conference. So the Volunteers trail by 3, 13-10, 3:21 to go, third quarter, and now they have the ball. They ran it down and got a field goal last time, primarily keeping it on the ground. Let's see if that continues. Big opening for Randall Morris to the 30. 34 yards on the run. Davis and Hall with a tackle.
Defensively, if you're in the I formation, defensively, you have to stay behind the football. There's Freddie Nunn. Freddie Nunn has to flatten out his angle. He should make that play. But Morris breaks into the secondary. Now Lee Davis is just trying to buy time. Hold him up till Hall can get there. Hall hustles all the way from the strong safety position and makes the play.
Ole Miss has called timeout. As you look at the Tennessee cheerleaders, the entire defensive unit went to the far sideline to get some coaching, and now the entire Tennessee offensive unit comes to the side. We'll be back.
Someday soon, you could very well have the best of everything, but you will have to begin somewhere. And the best place to begin is with the very best beer in the world. The best tasting beer wherever you go. When you think about it, why would you ever have anything else?
Come to think of it, I'll have a Heineken.
Chevy Chop taking charge.
Water. In all of nature, there's nothing like the thrill of an S10 Blazer. Chevy Tahoe is taking charge.
The Rebels of Ole Miss will be selecting one of those Ole Miss Rebels as the most valuable player tonight, along with one of the Tennessee Volunteers. Then Chevrolet will be donating $1,000 scholarship to each school. Ole Miss with new helmet designs this year. Billy Brewer's asking us yesterday what we thought of them. Him and I decided we think they're television attractive. Good idea. As is the orange tee on the helmet of Cockrell of Tennessee. Hands off to the fullback on the first down 10. To the 30-yard line goes Big Sam Henderson. Tennessee's been able to use all three of those workhorses, Morris, Miller, and Henderson, and they're at fullback tonight, and it's helped them a lot in this second-half ground game. And Billy Brewer's defensive unit digging in inside their own 30 now.
Mississippi maintained control of the football for a good portion of the first half. They've only had one possession in the second half, haven't had the ball much.
Cockrell keeps it, Hopkins. That's Randall Morris knocked out of bounds. Oh, what a slick job of ball handling by Alan Cockrell. Faking, then rolling on the option down to the 23-yard line, first down.
Good job of faking, sucks in the linebackers from Mississippi. Now the toss to Morris.
Cockrell, a very slick ball handler. He is an outstanding baseball player, too, by the way. Was drafted a year or so ago by the Toronto Blue Jays. And Morris is really tacking up the yards, 97 tonight. He had 230. Uh-oh. Tennessee offensive line, I believe, moved over on the right side. The penalty markers go down. Ole Miss jumped over and touched one of the Tennessee players. Now the discussion and the announcement will come up in a moment. We have 2:33 to go in the third quarter. It's Ole Miss 13, Tennessee 10 from Neyland Stadium in Knoxville. They're saying Tennessee did not move and that the Ole Miss player jumped offside. Big call here. It'll be first and five when we come back for Volunteers.
Dead ball. Offside.
It's always a chance you take if you're a defender. If you pick up some movement, you got to try to make sure that the referee sees it too.
That was 48 Carl Lewis over the defensive left end who made the move over there and reached over and touched 58 Steve Knight of Tennessee. All right, now it is first down, five Volunteers. They're at the 18-yard line of Ole Miss.
Fumble! Who's going to get it? Tennessee fell on it, I believe. Wait a minute. Morris fumbled the ball. Ole Miss, there they have it, but the officials say no, it is still Volunteer ball. I think Randall Morris came back and got it.
A little positive thinking there by Andre Townsend. It's a missed handoff here. It's a matter of concentration. The ball seemed to be in there. Maybe it stuck on Cockrell's palm as he pulled it out. Kind of banged him in the hip.
Now second down, nine, Tennessee. They're back to the 22, but they're glad they still have the ball. Volunteers back to the nine. Here comes that option again. Morris.
He has running room. Fumble. Ole Miss fell on it at the 1 yard line. Ole Miss with the ball. Morris was about to go into the end zone to give the Volunteers a lead when the ball came loose. I think 48 Lewis, the man you see running off the field, got the ball, Tim Foley.
Joe Hall reaches inside and just yanks the ball free from Randall Morris. Heady heads-up football play by Joe Hall.
People might give you their trust once, but after that, it must be earned. That's why we at Emory are proud to be the overnight delivery service so often relied on to deliver in the clutch.
Good breath. Not bad. Maybe you could use a little pine tar. Thanks. I really missed it.
Emory, we've earned the trust of American business.
Let's look at that play and the fumble again, Jim.
Good-looking play by Tennessee. Cockrell fakes, moves down the line of scrimmage. Defensive end takes him, and then two players overrun the play for Mississippi. It looks like it's going to be a touchdown, but Joe Hall, the guy they say is the real cowbell of this defense. He doesn't lead it in tackles or in interceptions, but he's an emotional and a spiritual leader down there. And there's the man that recovered it, Carl Lewis.
Right there when he needed to be. Ole Miss has to line up in the end zone, first and 10 from the one.
Little bit of running room out to the 8-yard line comes Arthur Humphrey, the fullback. Humphrey has his most important carry of the night down that deep. He has 47 yards on the night. McGee has 58. Scholes with a tackle for Tennessee.
1:22 left in the third quarter of play. Mississippi has just dodged the bullet.
Second down, 3, Ole Miss. Drive out near the 10. They have to go to the 11 and pass it for the first down. That was Humphrey Williams with the tackle. This is where that Tennessee defensive unit, it's almost as though they have their backs to the wall, even though they're down in Ole Miss territory. Short of the first down, it'll be third down, 1.
Mississippi has to make this first down and then maintain possession of the ball for a while to give that defense a rest.
Down for the Rebels. There are about 3,500 Ole Miss fans here in Neyland Stadium tonight. Remember, there are about 90,000 all total in here. That little group huddled over on the sideline near the Ole Miss band has something to cheer about as the Rebels are leading 13-10, only 20 seconds remaining in the third quarter.
Reggie White is amazing. He covers so much ground laterally along the line of scrimmage.
Quick handoff, Humphrey to the 16. Tackled by middle guard Johnny Williams, who's had 10 tackles tonight for Tennessee. One of the reasons is that Ole Miss has been running it right up the gut time after time. That's going to be the end of the third quarter. We have only 15 minutes of football left from Knoxville. It's 13-10, Ole Miss leading the 6-2 Volunteers.
Test pilot Chuck Yeager for AC Delco.
In a high-performance fighter, we go from the griddle to more than 20 degrees below in just seconds. Well, here's an all-weather fighter for your car, the new Delco Freedom Dura Power Battery. Hot or cold, it's got the starting power you can depend on. With a Freedom Battery, you never need to add a drop of water.
Get a Delco Freedom Battery starting at $39.95 for a 40 series. Call 800-AC-DELCO.
Watch out, kids. I'm going quick, quick, quick. I'm gonna get you with the Kodak Fist. I'm gonna get you with the Kodak Fist. Sure as shooting, I'm not gonna miss. You know anything that's easy as this. I'm gonna get you with the Kodak Fist, yeah. I'm gonna get every doggone shot. I'm gonna get you, catch you, tell your car. I'm gonna get you, ready or not. I'm gonna get you with Kodak Fist. Just kiss. The Kodak Fist camera clicks from picture to picture automatically. Easy to load, and its built-in flash knows when to flash. See? Want a camera that's easier and more fun than that? You're not gonna get it. I'm gonna get you with a Kodak Fist. I'm gonna get you, whoop, just like this. Ask me how I do it, it's all in the wrist. I'm gonna get you with the Kodak Fist. Look out, I'm gonna get you with the Kodak Fist. Hi, Mom, you better look cute, cause it's ready and shoot. I'm gonna get you with the Kodak Fist.
They wanted somebody new.
If you can make the numbers work, it means the big time.
That's why you've got the Rainbow, the new personal computer from Digital with two separate microprocessors. One for today's jobs, another for tomorrow. It's like getting two computers for the price of one.
That's it. Welcome to the big time.
The Rainbow from Digital Equipment Corporation. Call 1-800-DIGITAL for the store nearest you.
The fourth quarter of tonight's game is brought to you in part by Chevrolet. Chevrolet is USA 1, and USA 1 is taking charge. By America's number one imported beer, Heineken. Just say, come to think of it, I'll have a Heineken. And by the world's second largest computer company, Digital Equipment Corporation. There's Bob Neal and Tim Foley high above Neyland Stadium. Tim from Miami. He's a little cold, but one of the volunteers brought him some great muffs. Tim, can you hear me? Tim Foley. Tennessee earmuff warmer. It's about 33 degrees here. Beginning of the second of the fourth quarter. Second down, 7. They got it. It's wide open, and it's incomplete at the 44-yard line. Stephen Cunningham, the intent. the pressure on Powell. He was leveled just before he threw the ball. Or excuse me, McGee. But watch this. And look at, he was wide open. There was nobody close to him here. They took advantage of that aggressive Tennessee secondary that's been coming up and supporting in such fine fashion. Cunningham had slipped behind everyone. Well, McGee had a chance to throw the pass complete, but was really level. Third down, 7. Listen to this crowd. It's complete. First down, Ole Miss at the 32-yard line. Timmy Moffitt with the reception. Terry Brown covering. And that was against the number one pass defense in the Southeastern Conference. Going to see the secondary play. Watch the tight end. He's moving through the middle of your screen. Now he's running down toward the bottom of your screen. He holds the linebackers. You see how they sit down and move toward him? And that opens up the area right behind him. Nice throw by Kelly Powell to Moffitt.
From the 31-yard line, first down 10. Ole Miss Rebels, they lead 13-10. Powell under pressure. Tennessee just back there time and time again. Reggie White. It won't go down as a sack, but you can call it a quarterback pressure.
Watch Reggie White at the top of your screen. This is one of the few times that guard, number 57, is there to help out on the inside, or it was the center, Wayne Pierce. They're double-teaming him most of the night. They're trying to get two people on him all the time. The tackle is supposed to overplay him on the outside, expecting help from either the center or the guard on the inside.
One of the 12 nominees for the Lombardi Trophy. College football's outstanding lineman. Second down, 10, Buford McGee. He doesn't get much. This Tennessee defensive unit knows they are going to have to shut down the Rebels here because they're already staring at the field position change. Dale Jones with the tackle. Johnny Majors agreed with Billy Brewer on one thing about this game, and that is that field position was going to play a very important role.
This crowd to his play against LSU, and he's the one that's the catalyst again tonight.
Third down, 9. Ole Miss from their own 33. They lead 13-10. We're in the fourth quarter. Powell under pressure. They found the whistle. It's going to be a delay of the game call against Tennessee, I believe. The 25-second time had elapsed, and Alan Cockrell told me yesterday when Tennessee came to warm up, we're going to try to get up to the line as soon as we can because we need to make that call. He said, I think it could be a real, we know about the noise. It could be a real problem for Ole Miss. It turns out to be one here.
Dead ball. Delay of game. 25-second count. Third down.
25 seconds is really getting done things in a hurry. In professional football, you have 30 seconds to get a playoff, and sometimes even those throws are rushed.
Cockrell said he knew at Neyland Stadium, you got to get up there in a hurry because of this noise, because you have to bark out the calls very slowly. Powell on 3rd and 14, throws it out of bounds. Tennessee's defense aided by the delay of game penalty holds. Now Ole Miss will have to turn the ball over. 13 minutes and 50 seconds remaining in this football game. It has been tight all the way. Tennessee took an early 7-0 lead, then led 7-3, then were behind 10-7. Then it was 13-7, then a field goal by Tennessee made it 13-10. There's Smith, fifth punt of the night, averaging 42.5 yards a punt. McGee at his 30.
Has a wall. He falls down.
Gets to the 45-yard line of Ole Miss. 42-yard punt. 25-yard return. We're just getting down to it here at Neyland Stadium. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
MCA Country Grace, John Conley.
I'm only in it for the love.
Barbara Mandrell. The Oak Ridge Boys. And 1983 CMA Country Vocalist of the Year, Lee Greenwood. Great country gift on MCA Records and Cassette.
Come on in, take a seat. We're gonna tell you what the big boys eat. Name is Wee Wee Country Wee. Now you know what the big boys eat. Hello, Slim. Come on in. Jump in, Barry. Have a swim. Wee 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 Country Wee. Now go tell your mama what the big boys.
Part of your good breakfast.
Atlanta Braves apparel and gifts for your friends and family through the Braves Clubhouse Collection. To get your catalog, send $1 to Braves Catalog, Post Office Box 4064, Atlanta, Georgia, 30302. The dollar will be refunded with your first order. Rowan Backfish, our associate producer's mother, celebrating her birthday here on November 12th. Happy birthday to Rowan's mom. The center and the quarterback, that's Treno and Cockrell, with a little bit of problem on the timing, but the center snapped the ball, nobody else moved, no flag. But also not much else happening on that play for Tennessee. Watch this.
Cockrell not expecting the football. One of the things that an offensive team does against a defensive line that moves and shifts a lot, often they'll come up to the line and go on the first sound. The quarterback will go cut, and then they go. And that'll prevent that defense from moving so much. They'll be a little bit more concerned about their move.
You don't see it very often. Streno, a senior, he's worked with Cockrell a long time. Here's a reverse. McGee, however, has nothing going at all. Number 88, Bob Blakemore, is back there to stop 88 for Tennessee. Big loss on the play, about 10 yards.
Well, Blakemore's a Tennessee product, and you can bet he's excited about this football. They had a wall set up, and it looked good, but Blakemore stayed right at home, took care of his responsibility. Is putting McGee on the ground that time.
The Tennessee's defensive unit, aided by a penalty, was able to stop the Ole Miss drive. Tennessee now trailing in this game. They're not used to trailing when they play here at Neyland Stadium. And here's a big conversion situation. Third down, 19, Cockrell. Complete at the 40. It is about 5 yards short of the first down. Tim McGee, the man with the reception. They're going to say it was at the 41.
A little bit of zone coverage here for Mississippi. This might put them into a situation where they could go for it on fourth down. Nice throw by Cockrell. Good, Truett in good position to make the play. And McGee seems to have had the wind knocked out of him.
Checking on him on the sideline. Tennessee has decided to punt. They have a great inside the 20 punter, a man who can get it down inside the 20 or the 10, and Jimmy Colson. Second punter in the SEC. Ole Miss has decided to call time out to decide exactly what to do here.
Well, they've got a little bit of confusion in terms of their personnel.
Billy Brewer is going to straighten that out, and we'll be right back. 11:38 to go in the game. Ole Miss leading 13-10.
A lot of good old boys around here know the best places to hunt and fish. Places that are hard to get to and get through and get around. That's why they got the original, the Honda ATC. The ATC will get you through water, it'll get you through swamp and mud. The fact is, the ATC works so good down here. There's a story going around that Mr. Honda used to live on the bayou. Everybody knows he lived up by Shreveport.
You know, if there's one thing we insist on, it's originality. In our music and in our clothes. And that's why we wear original members only.
The fit and style fit our style.
Hey, speaking of style.
And remember, it's not really members only unless it says so.
Right here on the pocket.
Members only. When you put it on, something happens.
The National Football Foundation's College Football Hall of Fame is a unique home for one of America's most colorful traditions. Located at Kings Island, Ohio, on Interstate 71 just north of Cincinnati, relive the rich history of college football. It's a part of Americana you and your family don't want to miss. The preceding message provided by the NCAA. You got Americana right here, folks. Southeastern Conference football. A lot of people around the country, football experts, think the SEC is the toughest conference in the nation this year. And these two teams are two of the best in the conference at this time of the season. Ole Miss on a three-game winning streak. Tennessee on a five-game winning streak. Here's Colquitt. Moffitt. Single safety's back. Look at this. It goes into the end zone. Penalty marker is down.
Bob, Tennessee has been successful moving the ball on the ground. Whenever they go to throwing it or try to do something fancy, it has backfired on them so far tonight.
They pick up the penalty markers down there. The official said it was an official timeout. They pick them up, put them back in their pocket, so there was no penalty on the play. It'll be first down 10, Ole Miss. They cannot wait to get to the line of scrimmage. Rebels leading 13-10 here at Neyland Stadium in Knoxville. 11:29 to go in the ball game. Hand off Humphreys. Running room to the 27-yard line for Humphreys. 7 yards right off the right side. A misdirection play by the Ole Miss Rebels. They continue to keep the ball on the ground. McGee has 17 carries but only 39 yards. Humphrey has 11 carries and 61. Look at score updates there. LSU losing again, 35-14 in the third quarter to Mississippi State. SEC action tonight. Humphrey stops short of the first down to the 29-yard line.
The mission of the Mississippi offense is do not turn it over, no fumbles, no interceptions, and maintain possession of the ball as long as you can.
This is the first time that an Ole Miss-Tennessee game has been on national television. They played twice on regional television in 65 and 1973. Both times, Ole Miss won the game. Double tight end, Smith and Joyner in there for Ole Miss. It is third down, very short yardage. First down, it is Arthur Humphrey. Humphrey was... Billy Brewer talking to me this morning at Alcoa High School out here in Tennessee. Gives up the first down. They're moving to six right now. He was talking to me at the practice this morning. He said, I think one of the keys to the game could be the play of my fullback, Arthur Humphrey. If he can be successful, we can be successful. From the 31, first down, Ole Miss. They lead by three. Powell, batted down. It was Robbie Scott, the freshman middle guard, number 65.
Another big play by Robbie Scott. He made a big play in the second quarter on the Tennessee goal line stand. The tight end is wide open against the zone here. Powell has been precision sharp all night long, knocks it down.
Kim Anderson, our spotter, has been precision sharp from our press box location tonight, too. David Farrell with his stats also doing a good job as usual. Second down, 10, Ole Miss from the 31. And off out to the 35-yard line goes Humphrey, tripped up by number 92, Reggie White.
Well, that's the first time they've given it to the fullback on the option. Trying to make Tennessee aware of everything. They can be concerned about defending every aspect of that particular play, the option.
Johnny Majors is concerned. As you see that there's just 9 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in this game. Tennessee trailing by three. They are 6-2 on the season. Bowl bids await the Volunteers if they can beat Mississippi. Third down, six. Powell under pressure. Down he goes. Number 92, the Minister of Defense, Reggie White, the third sack tonight.
We're going to watch Reggie White here. He's working against two Mississippi Rebels. He's even being held, but that's okay. He shakes it off and works his way through. Nice job of coverage there by the Tennessee secondary. Powell unable to unload the football.
Smith with the punt. It's a beauty. What a great punter this freshman is. McGee at the 19, looking for a wall. Finding one. Penalty marker clipping back at the 27. There was a potentially great block thrown by one of the Volunteer punt return blockers, but the official calls clipping, and it'll come way back. See if you can see it in this replay. That was a 39-yard return.
Number 75 chasing there is Dan Boyce. Toes came along, and they called that a clip.
may have called blocking below the waist.
That's correct.
Could be either one. His head looked like it was behind him, too, so it could go either way. Same difference. It nullified a great return.
Against LSU, Tennessee's punt return team and punt block team really exerted a lot of influence on the final outcome of that football game.
Blocking below the waist. On the kick return. First down. Timeout.
Now we've got a timeout down there at the 13-yard line with 8:27 remaining in this game. Ole Miss leads 13-10, and Tennessee's a long way from getting back in it.
That rotating mirrored ball might have been the inspiration for a remarkable breakthrough at Xerox. See, by aiming a laser beam at rotating mirrors, you can disperse it and use it to create the image of an entire page in a split second. And that makes electronic printing possible. People at Xerox tell me electronic printing is growing as fast as the copier did in the 60s. Isn't it nice to know Xerox invented them both? I know, you're saying, what kind of company is this Xerox? Ideas and dance halls? One of their scientists said, a great idea doesn't just fall into your lap. He said, you've got to go out and look for it.
Even if it means every once in a while, you may have to go dancing.
To create, reproduce, preserve, and share information around the office and around the world. From Xerox.
Sunday, November 20th, join Ken Squire and Cale Yarbrough for live flag-to-flag coverage of the Western 500 from Riverside on Superstation WTBS.
Volunteers ball, first and 10 from the 13. Cockrell. Incomplete. Cockrell was just leveled back there at about the 5-yard line, as you see. Ole Miss applying some defensive pressure as their own here tonight.
I've been impressed with the secondary of Ole Miss. Ron Case, defensive backfield coach, has done a fine job. That comparison there, total yards.
Second down, 10. Tennessee from their own 13. They trail Ole Miss, 13-10. 8:21 to go in the game. Hand off to the tailback. Morris knocked down at the line of scrimmage. Excellent penetration and then pursuit by Ole Miss. Their fastest defensive lineman, number 31, Freddie Nunn, ran him down. Nunn runs, according to Billy Brewer, a legitimate 4-5-40, and he plays defensive end, and he's 6'5". Ole Miss offensive unit listening to instructions on the sideline. You see 40 Humphrey pumping him up, and you see Ken McGee talking to him. These players are feeling it right now.
And that was Robert McGraw, the offensive coordinator and line coach, encouraging his players.
Second down, 8. Good end zone view of Cockrell. Incomplete. Lenny Taylor wide open. Oh, does he wish he had that back? Tennessee's going to have to turn over the ball again. 27 is Barry Wilburn. He goes back to take the punt reception along with Tim Moffitt, number 30. And that's not Alec Cockrell. That's Jimmy Colt with the punter.
Mississippi was fortunate on that play. They had some confusion in the secondary. Lenny Taylor was open but was unable to hang on to the football.
Threw 6 punts tonight. Colquitt's been averaging about 43 yards a punt. It gets loose down there, but it has fallen on by Wilburn, number 27, and that's at the 47-yard line. Ole Miss has excellent field position. 37-yard punt. Colquitt's had a couple of times tonight where he couldn't really get his foot into it at a crucial time. Far below his average when he punts one 37 yards. 7 minutes, 23 seconds remaining in this game. Ole Miss leads 13-10, and now they have the ball.
$255.
A certain overnight express company makes you pay a lot for little mistakes.
No zip code in the address, a $5 fine.
Absolutely positively.
At Purolator Courier, we don't fine you for little mistakes. We go out of our way to do things your way. Maybe that's why we deliver more packages overnight in the U.S. than any other courier.
Here's a doozy.
Ooh.
Purolator Courier. You want it, you got it.
presenting Magnavox and Ralph.
Attaboy, Ralph. Another day with my Magnavox. Look at that Magnavox picture. It's so bright and clear and so reliable. Whenever I'm ready, my Magnavox is ready. Yes, sir. If there's one thing I can count on, it's my Magnavox. And my dog, Ralph, here. If you want reliability, get a Magnavox. Because I'm not giving up Ralph.
Magnavox. The performance lasts.
Catch all the high-flying, slam-dunking action when the San Diego Clippers take on the Atlanta Hawks. Tuesday night, 8:05 Eastern, on Superstation WTBS.
Well, there's the story, folks. Ole Miss leading 13-10. We have 7:23 to go in the fourth quarter. Ole Miss ball, first down 10 from their 47. Humphrey with the ball, hit at the line of scrimmage. Not much gain on the play. 46 Williams, initial tackler. The middle guard, who's played himself a whale of a ball game for Tennessee. He has 10 tackles on the night.
On this play, the nose guard has a tendency to get ahead of the play. This time, he stays behind the runner in anticipation of the cutback by Humphrey. Good play by Johnny Williams.
And you saw number 74 for Ole Miss, Greg Walker, blocking on 92, Reggie White of Tennessee. Walker is the youngster who was a tight end and just moved over there. He's done himself a proud job tonight on Reggie White. Second down, 10. Powell. It's complete. Short of the first down, 47-yard line of Tennessee. Receiver was Michael Smith Sander, the tackler for Tennessee. Linebacker number 45.
A zone defense by the Tennessee secondary. And this pass will be opened against the zone. This is something that you give up. The idea is to be smacking him when he catches it. Sander comes and does that.
Third down, 4. Big, crucial possession play for Ole Miss. They are 5 out of 9 on third down coming into this play. It's complete to Humphrey. He's got the first down, and he goes out of bounds at the 35-yard line of the Volunteers. Terry Brown, Alvin Tolles chasing him.
Tennessee in a man-to-man defense. Tolles got man-to-man coverage on the lead back here. He can't get out. He gets caught in the traffic. The big, big catch there. That's a big conversion for Mississippi. Maintaining possession of the football in good field position.
That clock ticking down. Only 6:34 remaining. It stopped while they set the six for the first down. Tennessee has 3 timeouts remaining. Ole Miss has only 1 timeout remaining. Tennessee trailing. It'll be most important to them at this point in the game. Handoff up the middle goes down to the 33-yard line with Arthur Humphrey, the fullback. And Humphrey just keeps running it in there. He has 72 yards now and 16 carries.
Tennessee is not a risk-oriented defense. They like to play coverage. They like to play things conservatively. They're getting into time now, though. 6 minutes, almost 6 minutes left in the football game, where they may have to start applying a little bit more pressure to Powell, start blitzing a little bit, and leave those defensive backs in man-to-man coverage.
Powell, 18 out of 30, 183 yards, 1 touchdown. Second down, 8. 5 defensive backs in there for Tennessee, so Mississippi tries to run it. Run it short of the first down, on the 48-yard line. It was Humphrey. Sanders again with a tackle. I said Sanders, of course, it's just C-A-N-R. Wouldn't want his mama up in Mendham, New Jersey, to think I've mispronouncing his name. He has 11 tackles on the night, and I've been saying it a lot here, too. Third down, 3. Another one of those conversion situations. Powell, plenty of time. Throws it up short of the first down. It went to Nathan Wansley, the backup tailback. His first time for playing tonight, number 32, Sims with the tackle. That'll be fourth down.
Same play they just run in the other third down situation, but Tommy Sims did an excellent job of reading it and reacting back to the football.
If they go for a field goal, it'll be a 44-yarder, and normally Bill Smith, the man who kicks off, tries those. Neil Tevan kicks the short field goal, and Smith kicks the long one. Smith is 6 out of 13 on the year. His longest is 39. Let's see what they do here. Trying to check out the situation down there. Tevan is 92 and Smith is 7. And we've got a timeout down on the field with 5 minutes and 2 seconds to go. In the ball game, it is 13-10. Ole Miss leading Tennessee, and they're going to go for the field goal. And let's see, it is. Tevan is going to try a 44-yarder. His longest of his career is 34. This one's a big one.
good. Tennessee dodges a bullet. So the Volunteers will take over at that line of scrimmage now, which is the 27-and-a-half-yard line with 4:44 to go in the game, trailing Ole Miss 13-10. Now let's go to Atlanta, Georgia for an update.
A defensive battle in the Big Ten. Iowa with the ball. Quarterback Chuck Long. The corner of the end zone, Eddie Phillips with the touchdown. Iowa over Michigan State 12-6. Iowa 8-2 and bowl bound. That's about it.
Iowa getting past Michigan State. That'll make our ISO cameraman Josh Marks very happy tonight. Iowa. That ball batted down. Cockrell wanted to come out to Duncan over to his right. It was knocked out of the air by that man there, number 48, Carl Lewis.
That's been a big play for them all year long. They throw it. It's a quick hit to the wide receiver. Lenny Taylor runs off the strong safety. Now the linemen come out. It's almost like a screen to the flanker. Lewis gets his hands up, knocks the ball out of the air. Second and 10.
Volunteers from their own 28-yard line. Cockrell's going to keep it, I think. Tackle from behind at the 23. 88, Bob Blakemore. Oh, what a night he's had tonight. Several big plays. Both times he made a big play on an unusual offensive play. One time it was a reverse. This time it's the quarterback keeper.
And it's a run all the way. Duncan's blocking inside. Taylor's blocking inside. Lewis does a nice job of turning the play back in to Blakemore.
Tennessee needs to convert, and it's a tough one. Third down 11. Five defensive backs in for Ole Miss. Split. Incomplete intended for Randall Norris at the 30-yard line. The pressure came from number 50, Lee Cole. The linebacker came right up the middle. Watch it.
The confusion, the blitz pickup for Tennessee. You see Cole's feet. Now you see the rest of them coming right up the middle. Blakemore had occupied a lineman, then dropped back into the pass coverage to pick up on a draw or a quick screen.
Cole put the punt. Again, not a really good punt by Colquitt standards. It goes down to the 35-yard line to Timmy Moffitt. Ole Miss gets the ball there. 3:46 to go in the game. Ole Miss leads 13-10. Only a 38-yard punt by Colquitt. By the way, while I have a moment, I wanted to say for Lee Cole, the man who made that great play on the quarterback pressure from Laurel, Mississippi, a young man who's a friend of his in the seventh grade at Jackson Medical Center in Jackson, Nathan Wells, is ill tonight. He's done on behalf of the entire Ole Miss team. He wanted to wish Nathan, the seventh grader, well. Ole Miss ball. Now they need to get some first downs to protect their three-point lead. Let's see how the Volunteer defense does. Humphrey broke the initial tackle there at the 35, spun forward, makes that Buford McGee, spun forward, and finally was brought down after a gain of about 3 or 4 yards.
He did that one all on his own. They tried to run a little inside trap, but there was nothing home for Buford McGee. Popped off and got a couple of yards by himself.
McGee has carried the ball 18 times tonight for only 39 yards. Second down, 7, Ole Miss. This is Humphrey. He gets the 40 and no more. Now, Ole Miss down to it again. Reggie White with a tackle that time. It'll be third down, 5. Brought down to 2:59. It is a three-point game. Let us not forget that Tennessee has one of the finest kickers in the country. He is 10th-ranked field goal kicker right now, but he may even be better than his ranking. If you look at Billy Brewer. Fuad Reves, the junior, can kick them from way out of there. So if Tennessee gets their hands on the ball, they only trail by 3. Let's see if Ole Miss can prevent that from happening. Power. Plenty of time. Man open. It's the tight end, Smith. And it's a first down, Ole Miss, by about a half a yard.
And this is the play that has led the Tennessee defense to death tonight. Tight end dragging across underneath the linebackers. Powell putting it right on the money before those backers can get there. See Dale Jones coming in, but it's too late.
Get this. Coming into this game, the tight end junior from Philadelphia, Michael Smith, had only 4 catches on the year. He has 7 tonight for 43 yards against the great Tennessee pass defense, which is ranked number 1 in the Southeast Conference.
They run it right up the middle for about 3 or 4 yards. They go to fullback Arthur Humphrey. That was Mark Studaway, the defensive right tackle, number 98 for Tennessee with a stop. Look at that clock, 2:10, 2:09, and counting. Tennessee trailing by three.
If you're a defensive player for Tennessee, you have to be thinking, grab the ball, get the ball out. If you're the first man to reach the ball carrier, hold him up. The second and third man coming in will try to knife that ball out of his grasp.
They say the great players make the great plays when it counts. We'll keep our eyes on Reggie White and see what happens. They run it up the middle, does Mississippi, to the 46-yard line of Tennessee. Arthur Humphrey is short of the first down. Reggie White did strip him up. It'll be third down, just a little bit to go, about a yard, a little less than a yard, as Tennessee calls timeout. They now have two timeouts remaining.
Billy Brewer, setting charts, aware of what's worked and what hasn't worked. They run the option. They're using the alternative of handing the ball to the fullback because the nose guard is now very concerned about the cutback, and he's not getting to the hole to stop that just a straight-ahead fullback dive. They're going to give the ball to, I'm sure they're going to give the ball to Humphrey.
The Ole Miss band playing. You look at this last three games, Ole Miss on a three-game win streak. They held TCU to 7 points, gave up only 14 to the high-powered offensive attack of Vanderbilt, gave up 24 to LSU, but scored 27 to win. So this defensive unit has started coming into its own for Ole Miss. And that quote earlier by an Ole Miss newspaper writer of grit, spit, and never quit has proven to be true for both the offense and defense of Ole Miss tonight. There's Humphrey, but the whistle sounded before the play. This could be a crucial call. It was third and one. Ole Miss got the first down. They may, however, have encroached or had illegal procedure, and it's going against Ole Miss, a crucial penalty here.
If he marks off that penalty, I think you've got to give a lot of credit to Carl Torbus, too. He's the defensive coordinator for Mississippi.
Dead ball, illegal procedure. Offense.
He went to high school right here at Austin East High School in Knoxville, played for Carson Newman. And he certainly developed a fine game plan for this game, and his players have played well.
All right, now we've got a different situation for Ole Miss. They may have to throw it. Third down, 6 from the midfield stripe. 1:23 to go in this game. Powell.
It's picked off, number 22, Charlie Davis. The 37-yard line. There's a penalty marker at the 35, but it was after the interception. No matter what the penalty call will be, the ball will remain in the possession of Tennessee. I believe. Wait a minute. Hold it. Could be pass interference. Wait a minute. They're going to call it back, I think. Let's just hold it and watch and listen to Bob Ia, the official.
I don't think so. I think it was blocking below the waist on the return.
You got
blocking
it right.
Below the waist on the return. First down.
Exactly right.
Charlie Davis also came up with a key interception against LSU. The same fashion they had him in man-to-man coverage on Smith. They tried to go to the well one too many times for the tight end.
1:14 to go in the game. Tennessee with two timeouts left from midfield. Cockrell.
Can't find anybody. Eluded the sack. He completes the pass to Henderson. Back to the original line of scrimmage.
That was a great play to avoid a loss by Alan Cockrell. Hubbard with the tackle. Second down, 10, Tennessee. Oh, what a job this Mississippi defense is doing here tonight. Time left in the game. 13-10 Ole Miss leading. Cockrell. It's complete. Out of bounds at the 45-yard line goes Randall Morris. It'll be third down, 5, Tennessee, with 44 seconds remaining in the game.
One of the most vulnerable areas in the zone defense, and I'm sure Mississippi's going to be playing some zone, is that 15 to 18-yard area right down the middle. Look for them to run the weak safety off with either Taylor or Duncan and bring the other one underneath.
Big play for Tennessee. You know they're going to go for it on fourth if they don't make it here. Third down and four. Cockrell in the pocket, running out of the pocket, throwing.
Intercepted Ole Miss at the 42 and up to the 45. And the Rebels have the ball with 35 seconds remaining. Roger Clark, the man who picked it off, number eight. Oh, boy.
Johnny Majors beside himself. I think that pass was intended for number 30, Kenneth Cooper, but Clark, number eight, got it for Ole Miss.
Doctor looking a little farther downfield initially. Excellent job of coverage by the Mississippi secondary. Finally, he turns, tries to hit Cooper. But Roger Clark, who earlier had an interception that resulted in a field goal, comes up with a big, big play.
That is going to fall on the ball. Tennessee has two timeouts remaining. Clock ticks the 32, the 31, the 30. Stops there. Tennessee uses one of their timeouts. You can figure it out with elementary math. Ole Miss has three more downs. Tennessee has only one more timeout. 25 seconds between. This ball game is all but over. Unbelievable. Ole Miss comes in to upset Tennessee. Volunteers were 6-2, Ole Miss 4-5. And I'll tell you what, once you look at the Ole Miss team physically stacked up against Tennessee, you wonder how they can do it. But they've got some great football players, and they've won three in a row, and you know that there's talent there for Ole Miss. And you've got these Rebels believing.
Well, that's the exciting thing about college football, Bob. And these youngsters get excited and decide they can do something. And Billy Brewer certainly convinced them that they could beat Tennessee. They came out and did the job. They overcame some adversity early in the football game, found themselves behind in front of 90,000 antagonists, behind 7-0, fought their way back and really controlled the line of scrimmage.
30 seconds to go. It's second down 12. That part's meaningless. What counts is whether or not Ole Miss fumbles the ball. And you can just about bet that Kelly Powell won. Johnny Majors, his team will go to 6-3. Tennessee has a couple of games remaining, so you can hurt for Johnny Majors a little, and you know he's hurting a lot right now. But Tennessee has yet to play at Kentucky, then entertain Vanderbilt here. Two more wins, Tennessee could, of course, go to an 8-3 record on the year, and that'll still get them in a bowl somewhere, so that's what they'll be talking about after this game.
When Valvoline announced its gold medal sale with special prices on Valvoline motor oil, we knew it would be popular, but we didn't know it would be like this.
I can't believe it's all gone.
Getting a top-quality motor oil, an oil that won a gold medal for lubricating excellence at a money-saving offer, is too good to pass up.
I can't believe it's all gone.
Better get yours now while you can. Look for Valvoline on sale where you see the gold medal sale sign. But hurry, it's going fast.
Hi. I'm Reggie Jackson. You know, I surround myself with the finest in classic cars. After all, I collect them. I also surround myself with something extra special in car audio. Panasonic car stereo with ambient sound. Unlike ordinary stereo, Panasonic ambient virtually surrounds me. Like I'm in a concert seat, not just a bucket seat. So listen to Reggie and listen to Panasonic ambient. That's Reggie sound.
Available at your local Panasonic car audio specialist.
For the Tennessee defensive unit, Reggie White, our most valuable player. You can be sure he would trade that in a minute for a victory here tonight. But he had two quarterback sacks, seven solo tackles, and this Tennessee defense gave up only 13 points, only one touchdown. They've played great, but so has the defensive unit of Ole Miss and the offensive unit in terms of controlling the ball with great leadership from Kelly Powell, the man you just saw fall on the ball. The clock is going to tick down. There's Buford McGee and Kelly Powell, number six, the most valuable player. What a great job of leadership he's done tonight and in the game since he came into that Vanderbilt game for Ole Miss. And Billy Brewer is calm and collected as he always appears, but you know he's cheering on the inside.
It's a big, big win for Mississippi. They had beaten Arkansas earlier in the year, and they've come back, and now they put four wins in a row together. They came in here as a 14-point underdog. I personally didn't think they could play with Tennessee. There's the expert analyst is wrong again, because when these young kids decide they're going to do something, they just get out and do it. Great game plan by Carl Torpich on defense for Mississippi, and they come out of here with a win.
The game plan for the Ole Miss Rebels worked both ways. They controlled the ball. Their defense played great. 13.